I'm addicted to success. What's up, what's up, what's up? Welcome to your new favorite podcast, The Ain't Shit Show, the home of booze, views, and unpopular opinions. I want to thank y'all for joining us for episode 72.
Yeah.
My name is Fresh, and I'm one half of the pod gods, and with me is the best man in all the podcast land, Chopper Slim, a.k.a. B.A.
Yeah. Put that chop on your ass, slimly. Slimming. Hey. Run up, they gonna get hit with slim chop. You know what I mean? That's the diet. That's the diet, AK-47.
That's the diet?
The slim. It's vegan. It's a vegan AK-47.
What I was. That shit shoot out broccoli.
That shit a whoopee. Kill you, but like keep you alive.
Hey, like, that chopper slim got some lambs.
Yeah, it won't wound you too bad. You know what I'm saying?
Just give you some splinters or some shit.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Just it'll twist your ankle.
Enough that you know what's going on, you should run.
You could dodge my shit. Like, you could dodge it. You know what I mean? You could dodge it a little bit and then just twist your ankle and be mad as fuck.
Oh, man. What's going on with your low-calorie AK-47? How have you been, my friend?
Good, man. High as hell right now.
Word.
Yeah, so.
Nice.
Yeah, I'm always fucking high. Weed is the way. I'm great, man. Went to see the movies. It was a content-filled weekend for me, personally. Like, a bunch of good basketball. Yeah. And Game of Thrones episode was interesting.
I heard the geeks got their life this weekend. Avengers made like 1.2 billion.
Yeah, I saw Avengers on Saturday, and then I saw at 1 o'clock that shit was fucking awesome. That's like one of the best movies I've ever seen in my life.
A lot of people say that. What made it so great? Tell us about Avengers.
It was just excellent. Like, it's just the writing and the directing. Like, you obviously have to watch it and enjoy it, but even not necessarily, because just from a directing and acting standpoint, like the way they incorporated like the past, like it was like a precursor to it, just in case you hadn't seen it all, like to kind of let you know what happened prior to that. Like, if you seen Infinity War but hadn't seen anything else, it'll go like all the way back in time. But it was ill, like how you going back in time, but like you can't fuck nothing up. But mad shit happens to you. I don't know. It was just well done.
And like then, the butterfly effect,
kind of, sort of, but like, in a different type of way, though. Like, it was it was crazy, man. Like, it was a really good movie. It was long. It was 3 hours. I enjoyed all of it.
Ooh, chillax. 3 hours.
Yeah. Motherfuckers fell asleep on it. I know some people that fell asleep just because they was tired, but, like, it was, man, I ain't fall asleep worth a damn. I was pumped up the whole fucking
time. 1.2 Billy, niggas better be staying up for that $15. Shit, nigga, and then I know if you saw the shit in IMAX, it'd be up to $25.
That shit was good as hell, yo. Like, I ain't lying. Like, me and my old lady went on Saturday at 1 o'clock in the afternoon, and that shit was sold out. Like, damn near. That was the only time that we could see it, probably before Sunday. And I was like, fuck that shit. So I got somebody to watch the kids. And we dipped, and then, shit, that was pretty much all our day, because that was the whole fucking movie. I mean, the whole afternoon and shit, I was fine with it. So, really good movie, though. They had, like, one of the best fight scenes ever. Like, that shit was, I don't know. If you, like, Thanos is a fucking monster. I ain't going to spoil it for nobody who ain't seen it, but next week, I'm going to spoil it. If I haven't talked about it. So, watch it this week.
Next week, y'all got next week to watch that. I've heard nothing but positive things about it from all the Marvel heads.
Hell yeah.
The moms who have gotten pulled into superhero shit because they got little boys and shit.
That shit was dope. I took him to see Shazam. Shazam was trash, though. That's like a DC movie. DC movies is fucking trash in comparison. They're just not good movies.
That's what I hear from the nerds.
Them niggas is trash. Like, Marvel is way better. Like, Marvel, like, even they B movies and C movies be fire. And like, DC movies, like, whoever the fucking director and the production team behind them niggas is trash. Like, they should be just
so give for us people who don't really know, who don't follow shit and like
geek world,
like shit like nerd that, and nerd virgin world. But give us some DC characters and give Superman, us some Marvel Batman. Characters.
Okay. DC characters: Superman, Batman,
Spider-Man,
Aquaman. No, Spider-Man is a Marvel character.
Really?
But yeah. He's okay. A Marvel character. But yeah, you had like Superman, Wonder Woman. Aquaman was really good, though. I will say that. Like, Aquaman was a really good movie. That was the best DC movie that they've had. And the acting was still kind of corny, but the visuals were like really dope. But the acting was trash.
Okay.
But like Marvel.
So is it a bigger budget?
I don't know.
I'm saying like visually, does it look different?
Nah, it's
like,
just they don't make good storylines. Like it's just not gotcha. Like a good. You know what I mean? Like it's just not good. It's not a good storyline. You know what I mean?
And who are the Marvel people?
You said
I
what?
Cut you off. I had cut
that
you
was,
off.
That's like Iron Man, fucking Thor.
Okay, there's Black Panther.
Hulk, Black Panther. Okay. I'm trying to think. X-Men, like all the X-Men, that's Marvel Universe too, like Wolverine and Cyclops and all that shit. Which they got a movie coming out that's going to be dope too.
When you were younger, before all the big budget movies and shit like that, you followed like comic books and
shit
like
that? Yeah, I used
to
like, I was really like big into X-Men though. Like X-Men, my shit.
I got put on the X-Men. That's one of the few I will go see.
I'll go see
X-Men, and I don't even know if Transformers fall into the genre, but when I think about it.
Yeah, I mean, it was comic books. That's what it originated from. All that shit originated from comic books and shit, you know what I mean? So I used to like comic books and, like, you know, reading them stories and shit like that. So that shit was dope for me. Like, but I used to like Superman, Batman, all that shit. Like, I always like all superheroes.
But was DC, was Marvel always in the lead? Like, as far as...
Nah, they came on late. Like, the first Marvel movie was probably, like, in 99 or 98 or some shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, DC, like, all the Batmans, like, with fucking, goddamn Kevin Costner and... Was it Kevin Costner? No, not Kevin Costner. What was that nigga name? Bruce Willis? Nope, won't him either.
What we talking about?
Penguin.
Oh, you talking about Heath Ledger and all of
that? Nah, that was...
The niggas
that
who
was
died?
The best. Now that's, I was talking about before all that, like when we was kids, when we was coming up. What the fuck is that nigga name,
you
man?
Talking about Michael Keaton.
Michael Keaton. I said all the white men except for that man. I miss Nicolas Cage.
And I remember that nigga, like how I remember.
Yeah, I know. That's crazy. Thank you. Come off the top rope.
My brain has a bunch of useless facts in it.
Me too,
sure.
Brother. That should be, that should be random as hell, like mad useless ass facts. Like, come on, like, hey, did you know? Like, no. I don't give a fuck about that.
Like, but, weirdo.
Fucking rest in peace to Heath Ledger, because that was the best Batman movie of all time. That's one of the greatest movies.
That was
period.
Dark Knight, right?
Yeah, Dark Knight was crazy. Like, outside of it, like, it was some of the best cinematography in the world. Like, it was this part when the Joker was riding with his head out the fucking window and shit. And, like, after he was as crazy as fuck. And, like, that shit, the way it was shot, like, that shit was so crazy, man. Like, I don't know. I like a lot of, like, cinematography and shit. I should have went to fucking movie school or film school, I guess, but. I'd be seeing
movie
mad
school,
little,
yeah.
You know what I mean? Shit like that. That really like entertains me. Shit. That's why I like Spike Lee. Some of his it's either you like a lot of Spike Lee or you don't. And like some of the I remember some of the shots that he took that were kind of like revolutionary in film world and shit. But so that was that. And then Game of Thrones came on Sunday, and Game of Thrones was interesting. I wish you watched fucking Game of Thrones. I need, like, it would be great content, because I've been listening to it's been some crazy podcasts about the shit, but it was really good.
Yeah, it's like a million Game of Thrones recap podcasts.
Yeah, for sure. It's crazy. It's like the one show that I can honestly say that everybody, meaning not everybody, obviously, because you don't watch it, but like,
majority of the world watches.
Like, demographically. Like, every fucking class and, you know what I mean? Like, you got rich motherfuckers who watch it, and, like, football players and goddamn nerds. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just, like, all, like, a street
crazy.
Niggas. I know street niggas that watch that shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, all different type of people. And it's like, and it's like, it's kind of like a sport in a sense. Cause, like, that's one thing about sports. Like, sports is, like, one of those ties that bind, like, all walks of life come in. You know what I mean? Root on the
but
same team.
I think sports and watching sports is still kind of mostly male dominated. Whereas
that's
Game of
too.
Thrones, it's literally everybody.
It literally fucking, you're right. Literally fucking everybody. You know what I mean? Like, and like, it was a little, like, it was good. I wish you watched it. God damn it. I wish you watched it so we could talk about it. That shit was, it would make great conversation. But, it was kind of dark. It was weird because they spent like $30 million on the shit. You know what I mean? And it's, the longest battle scene in history, and it was like literally an hour and a half, and it didn't necessarily have to be an hour and a half.
The one from last night?
Sunday, yes.
I mean, Sunday. Mm-hmm. My bad. Yeah, Sunday.
It was an hour and a half. It was good.
They spent $30 million on just the battle scene alone?
Just the battle scene alone. The longest battle ever. Well,
it must have been worth it because niggas was losing their mind on the timeline. And so I kind of skipped the Game of Thrones spoilers only because I do plan on at least attempting to watch it. So I don't get into it, but I just saw it a lot. Niggas was losing their mind. I said, oh, Game of Thrones must have been good tonight.
and it was, but it, like, looking back on it, it could have been so much better. Cause like the way Game of Thrones is, like Game of Thrones, there is no rhyme or reason. Motherfuckers just get killed. Like your favorite motherfucker that you fuck with and his whole goddamn family will die in a tragic way. You know what I'm saying? Like, and that shit come from completely left field. So you're invested in these characters and shit, and then niggas die. Niggas really didn't die this episode. You know, not like niggas died, but not like super
niggas
duper
died,
main.
But it was, not died, died.
It wasn't main characters that died. You know what I mean? And okay. It was supposed to have been some main characters. But, I mean, we got three more episodes. You know what I mean? So I'm pretty
That's
sure shit
crazy.
Gonna get funky.
That it's only three more episodes to the whole series, yeah, over, right?
So,
with the, so though. The first two was a little lackluster, I'm getting. From individuals, like they expected more, I guess, maybe because it's only six episodes.
Yeah,
or
they wanted it. Yeah, it I can agree to that. It wasn't, but they were still good. They were pieces in the puzzle, like to how it's supposed to, you know what I mean, the finale of it all. So they were like, they were pieces of the puzzle to that shit, but they were still good. I mean, everybody was watching. Like, it's just honestly, this season hasn't been as fucking you know what I'm saying, like as what I wanted. I kind of wanted more, but it's still like been good because it's they're gonna have to wrap the shit up. So I guess they're trying to wrap it up with. I don't
they
know
probably
the
gonna wait till like that them last two episodes and especially that last episode and just snatch all y'all wigs off.
Yeah,
like,
I mean, I think that's what's gonna happen. The ending gonna have to be crazy because like it had like up to this point, like the battle was good on Sunday and shit, but it could have been crazy. You know what I'm saying? Like knowing how Game of Thrones is and how fucking wicked that shit can be, it really wasn't wicked as it was supposed to be. You know what
yeah.
I mean? But it was still good though. You know what
Listen,
I mean?
Listen, I was at a friend house last week and they were catching up when I walked in. And I don't know what season or what episode or nothing, but it was on TV, but I really wasn't paying attention to it. Then I look over, I'm like, yo, this Game of Thrones. They like, yeah, you know, told you need to watch whatever. All I'm seeing is a bitch talk to a dragon. And then she says some shit like, oh, yeah, that's her baby or some shit like that. I was like, oh, this going to take a lot out of me to try this shit because this is not my lane at all.
I'm like, telling you, like, this is not it's so my big. It's so much tea. More than that. So once you see, like, how the dragons are incorporated into everything, like, I know it's far-fetched, but, like, this shit get nasty. Like, I don't know. I mean, I love it. I know, like, a lot of people love it. And, you know, I mean, I think you would
like it. No, I feel
like
99.9% of
America. It's like a fucking chess game. It's like literally a chess game because it's like live chess. That's the best way I can
explain it. Is it black people?
You say what?
Are there any black people?
Not very many.
Okay. I mean, why isn't there any black people?
I mean, because I don't know. I mean, I don't know. I mean, they got people of color, but I mean, there's black people here and there. I mean, but certain, I don't know. I don't really give a fuck about all that shit. It's just good fucking entertainment. You know what I mean? Like, I ain't really tripping in the whole fucking black versus white shit on that. Like, sometimes I just be wanting to watch some shit and not necessarily associate with color and shit. You know what I mean? And I'm just invested.
Cool.
Like, it's plenty of white shows that I've watched that are fucking good as fuck.
I'm just saying, if the shit fantasy, I thought if the shit was like set in like a real time or some shit, the shit sound like it's fantasy. I just want to know what's it.
I mean, they have
black
people, you know what I mean? But it's predominantly white, you know what I mean? Or like fucking.
I watched plenty of white shows.
Yeah.
It was
so
just a question.
That's what I'm saying. Like,
it's a question.
I've heard other people say that shit. Like, it ain't no black people in there. That's cool. I mean, but they haven't. So now, like, they're doing Before the Throne type shit, so it's like a precursor or the prequel to fucking Game of Thrones and shit, and it's gonna have like more diversity, like more women and fucking black people and shit, which is cool too. You know what I mean? Obviously, I want us to get all the jobs we can. So, I don't know. That shit good. I don't give a fuck. That shit good as fuck.
We can do Game of Wicker Thrones, where you used to take that picture in that club chair.
Oh, yeah.
Take that Wicker Throne picture.
Hey, he was beating my daddy got him. I had mad at him fucking up my real pop. That nigga had mad at him.
Oh, my weekend was cool. Thanks for asking.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Told you I'm
my out. Weekend was cool.
You go to the DJ Envy and them shit? They had that shit down there.
I didn't know about it. You ain't put me onto it.
Shit, I ain't know. They had the shit. He posted on
the house
and
shit. The house shit.
Mm-hmm.
Oh no, I ain't know about that. I don't follow DJ Envy.
Oh okay.
Yeah, I don't follow DJ Envy to know what he doing.
You should follow him.
DJ Envy, your man's. But when you see the house shit, send that shit to me.
Shit, it was just this weekend. I don't know when they're coming back.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just saying, if you see it again, send it to me.
Got you.
Yeah, but my weekend was cool or whatever. Productive, it was chill. I went to Groove 3rd anniversary. Groove is that R&B party I go to.
Groove is in the house. Oh yeah, I went to a fucking Drake night on Friday. I forgot about that.
I've been to a Drake night. I don't know if it's hosted by the same people.
It was like four people in there.
Oh word.
Yeah. And then it was so crazy because like the nigga who be throwing the parties and shit, like he had on his Instagram like, oh, we did over 1,000 people in the Ritz and shit. Like, man,
cap.
Over the course of time, because like maybe motherfuckers drifted in and drifted right the fuck out. That shit was trash.
What time you get there?
Late, like probably like 12:45, 1 o'clock.
Oh, alright. I was about to say, was you there at 10?
Nah, I definitely. Wasn't
I hate
at
people 10. Who want to get to the spot early, bro. I'm not an early spot. Like my nights.
I had mad
when it come
spots
to, like,
that night. It was weird. On shit.
When I
up.
Had parties and shit. When it's like party night, yeah. You know what I mean? Like you going to a party or some shit. Like, I hate going with them people. And it's the older people get. It's definitely the older people get like, oh yeah, the shit started at 10. Let's get there at 10:30. No, I'm not about to be at the spot at 10:30, man.
Like a club or like somebody house type shit?
No, like a club. Oh, like yeah, a club
nah,
or an event. Nah. Not at somebody's house.
Oh yeah, nah.
You know, you go to somebody's house, you need to get there at least within an hour.
I go to the bar before. Like, we go to the bar early.
Yeah, I don't really like going to spots early. I was telling my people, like, look, all I need is 2 hours.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Like, that's max. Like, all I need is 2 hours. I'm the type that I can go at 12:30.
Oh, yeah,
1 o'clock.
Sure.
Yeah, you know what I mean? I can go to the spot at 1 a.m.
I wish that bitch closed at 1 o'clock. So I could be there about 11. Like, shit, I'm going about 11.
Hey, I don't mind, but I'm not about to really spend 3-4 hours in those spots.
I ain't
trying to get there at 11.
Ladies be free before 9.
Leave at 1. I can't be rolling with them broke people either. Like, I'll meet you there, man. Like, I can't be getting in those spots. It's free before 11 for a reason, because ain't nobody in that bitch.
Right.
Like, so they trying to get people up in that joint. But I went to that. That was a good time. People was killing that. They was killing that Beyonce.
New shit.
Before I Let Go, Frankie Beverly jump. You like that jump?
It's cool. I like the original better, but it's cool.
Yeah. You know what? I have an unpopular opinion. I'm not a huge fan of Before I Let Go.
The original?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Right. That's what I said. Hot take, unpopular opinion.
This nigga don't be liking shit, bro.
Nigga, I like mad shit.
This nigga said she don't like fucking Before I Let Go.
I didn't say I didn't like it. I said I'm not a big fan.
Shit,
like that don't turn me up. I probably heard that song more than anybody else. Like, that song comes on at every single black club. And that's cool, but it ain't something where
time to go.
I go off to it. Yeah, like, it's not like my shit. The Beyonce joint, cool. It is what it is. You know what I'm saying? Frankie Beverly.
It's another girl that did a version of that shit. Fuck is her name. That shit is hard. I like that better than Beyonce shit. Is it Vivian Green that did that rendition?
I don't know no other rendition.
That shit hard. Like, I'm about to see. Hold on. That shit gonna burn me up.
Talk
amongst yourself.
While we talking about that, the weekend seemed like it was pretty lit. Going north, Broccoli Fest was this weekend.
Yeah, I heard that
in
shit
DC.
Was lit.
That shit was lit. Everybody who I know went told me that
I was
supposed to go.
Right.
That shit. It was Vivian Green.
Yeah, get right back to my baby. I'm gonna get right back to my baby. You don't remember that? You don't know that jump?
I don't know that song at all.
Hold on, I'm about to play it real quick one time.
Here he go.
Hold on, come on now. What the fuck? Oh, this is the Spanish version. That's a bop. Hey, you don't know that?
I never heard that song before.
You ain't never heard that song?
Uh-uh.
Wow.
Where you hear that?
The radio in mad places? Like, that should be in mad, like, restaurants and shit?
I've never heard that shit, bro.
You never heard that song?
I've never heard That's a rendition crazy. Of Before I Let Go. Ever.
That's fucking Besides Vivian the Frankie Beverly Gotta get right back. They done played that shit in all the black movies. That shit definitely been in Being Mary Jane. That shit definitely
I don't watch Being Mary Jane.
Definitely been in fucking mad shit. That shit is the BET go-to.
That particular song or the Frankie Beverly version?
No, that song. Like, they be playing the hell out of that song.
Bro. All right, we gonna go with the
watch the listeners be like you.
We gonna go with the B Hill facts. That was a B Hill fact. I feel like somebody gonna be like
shit. That shit. Done been in like all like goddamn.
Hey y'all, hit us if y'all done heard this version.
Vivian Green,
outside of
get
the
back
actual album. So do it. Just use the Before I Let Go beat.
It's a version of it. Like, didn't you hear? Oh, okay. You want to hear it again? Here we go.
I don't know. Play it. I'm just hearing the beat.
Hold on. Come on. You ain't never heard this? All right, we ain't gonna bore the. But that is a beautiful song. She killed that shit.
Okay. We'll take your word for it. Hey, let us know if y'all done heard that outside of the Vivian Green fans who know all of Vivian Green music. Because I've never heard that joke
That's crazy.
Before. Ever.
You probably don't like it anyway because you're a fucking hater.
I don't like Before I Let Go. I'm not a huge fan of Before I Let Go. Like, I can take it or leave it. Like, if it come on, it come on.
If you never hear it again, you cool too.
I'm never going to be in my house like, play Before I Let Go.
So you never like that's crazy. I love that shit, man. I went to Frank and Beverly Mays with my mom and them. We was like 11 with them. That shit was a dope show.
Listen. I got friends. I got exes. They love fucking Frankie Beverly. I'm good. I'm super cool.
That's crazy because it's damn near like fucking go-go music.
Is it though?
Yeah.
Is
it? I mean, it's like live instrumentation. Niggas singing, not saying a whole lot of words, but saying just enough. That's fucking go-go personified.
Don't be fucking disrespectful.
That Watch is. Out. What the fuck? Nigga, I'm comparing Go-Go to fucking Frankie Beverly and Maze, which is one of the greatest performers ever.
You well, whatever your description, I'm sure Go-Go and Frankie Beverly wouldn't like that description.
Like, it's not too far off from, it's the basis of it. Like, it's live instrumentation, a live band, like,
that's called
call
live
and
music.
Response type ass music. You know what I mean? Like, it has traces of Go-Go, guaranteed.
Alright, I'm gonna let you have that. Whatever.
But yeah, I definitely would have went to the Tide Water area. Shout out to fucking Pharrell and all the
Hold
good
on,
folks
see you still being disrespectful
shit.
Because we hadn't left Broccoli Fest yet.
Oh,
we're
I didn't
still
know you were
in
getting
DC.
That. I forgot about
we
that.
We said Broccoli Fest.
I always wanted we're to go to Broccoli Fest.
Listen, I'm going next year.
I was supposed to go the first year because Nip, and it's crazy. Shout out to Nip. But I was going to go to see Nip. It was Nip, Miguel, and Wayne was there. And I was like, holy shit, that's the fucking, like, that's my niggas. Like, all three in
Wayne
one.
Was here this year. Wayne was there this mm-hmm. year, too.
I saw that.
Wayne was there this year. Tiana killed it.
She always
City Girls.
It.
Childish Gambino. All of them was there.
Oh, have
so
you
that
seen the Childish Gambino and Rihanna movie?
No, but Guava I don't
Island.
Think that I am. You saw it?
Yes. Very interesting and very weird. And... Rihanna is
I saw
fucking
some
beautiful.
Clips from it, and I saw Childish Gambino being Childish Gambino. So I was just like, I think I'm cool. And then I didn't hear nobody talking about this shit, so
that
I was like, I'm
weird.
Super cool.
It's really weird. Like, I didn't know what to expect. He's just a weird dude, but it's actually dope because he's dope. Like, and Rihanna is, nigga, she is so fine in that motherfucker. Jesus Christ. Like,
that
I
is
really, fast. Like, just seeing her for a long period of time, like 30 minutes, 40 minutes.
Seeing her
like,
for a long period of time.
No, you know, videos and interviews and shit like that. Like, yeah. A little different. But this bitch was just like, her body was crazy. Her butt was all jiggly and shit. I was like, man, this motherfucker is fine. But,
all jiggly.
I love jiggly butts. But, but yeah, it was really weird.
Because we had our cellulite conversation, remember that?
Yeah, I like jiggle butts.
Yeah, you was team cellulite. But Rihanna is perfection.
Yeah, she dope, yo. Her titties, and like her titties, she got the right sag on the titties. You know what I'm saying? Like, like them titties are sagging, but they like the good sagging. You know
hey,
what I mean?
You a country nigga for real. Like that sound like my uncle. My uncles would say that shit.
Really?
Like my uncles from Mississippi would say that.
That's the right sag on them titties.
Hey, that's funny as shit.
It's just fine.
Moving along
like
to something
airbags
in the water.
Deflated just a little bit, but they like,
oh my God.
Still intact.
I will let you finish.
Yeah, go ahead.
Go ahead.
I'm
you,
good.
I'm gonna let you finish your wet dream about saggy titties.
Nah, they just like the right sag though. They ain't like them like they ain't them what was some shit? They ain't the crescent rolls. You know what I mean? Or the like udders off fucking cows and then. But they like ooh, they got see with the little saggy titties. You little they like the 29-year-old titties.
Oh okay.
Yeah.
What age are Rihanna titties?
They about 29.
29.
Yeah, they about 29.
Where it's like, you know, you still perky, but gravity didn't hit you
yeah,
just
like,
a little bit.
Yeah, you still like, you know what I mean? You like, you got like, you know what I mean? Like you got a job titties. You know what I mean? Like you got career ass titties.
I remember, always telling me like, talking about this chick, like, yo, like her body's so tight. Da 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 da. I was like, she a child. Gravity ain't hit her yet. She fucking 21. What the fuck you mean?
Yeah.
She ain't even got her grown up body yet. She can still wear the bra with the clip in the front.
That's
you
crazy.
Ain't even got to put that shit in the back.
Damn. I don't know if I seen a bra with a clip in the front.
When you clip it in the front, that's when you train it.
Mm.
See, you can, so for y'all fellas who don't understand how, women growing titties work, when you young and you get like your first bra and shit, you get like training bras and shit, most of the time they just look really like kind of like a camisole and it's like more like a sports bra type.
Mm.
But then like once you move up a little bit, you got the clip in the front. Your clip in the front because you in advance to put the bra on, spin it around, and then put your arms in it. Yeah. So, you know. But y'all don't know how bras work. That's how it works. And then by the time you get like in your 30s and shit, that's when you move to the bra. You go from like two clip. So you go from sports bra, clip in the front, to like two clips in the back, to like a whole motherfucking armored suit in the back where you got like 15 clips in the back.
That's some titties.
Like the clips on the back grow as you grow.
Yeah. I found like, so yeah, I remember I had found out with the titties cause I had like insulted a girl. I was like, what you got like a 38 double triple D? She's like, nah, like, cause I didn't know that the triple means how big you are. You know what I mean?
Yes.
The
number
the
is the circumference.
The yeah.
Of your body.
Yeah.
And the number is how big your titties are.
Yeah, nah. That shit. She was like, nah, nigga, I ain't big. You think I'm fat? I was like, nah, I ain't know that. I ain't try to, you know what I'm saying?
What size you said she wore?
She wore a 38D.
Okay.
Yeah. So she
nah,
like,
that's not that bad.
Yeah.
That's average.
Big
38D.
Titty.
Nah, I mean, anything over C is some nice titties. Like, I feel like everybody should have at least C titties.
Yeah. Why are you like, you should
like B titties. You could be young, but you got to grow up.
Yeah. It's like, you can't even come outside. Can you come outside? Can you come outside, titty? You got to come out. Can you come outside, titty?
Well, yeah, you come outside, titty.
And can you come
you
outside?
You still got your clip in the front, titty.
Yeah, I'm sure it's just, no.
Hey, you stupid. Something in the water, though. We were talking about something in the water.
Oh, yeah.
Something in the water making your titties grow. but that was lit. That seemed like it was pretty lit. It had like Timberland,
everybody.
Missy, Diddy.
They said that shit was super organized and like no
for the
issues.
First one, shout out to Norfolk. Shout out to DC too for Broccoli Fest. Shout out to Norfolk.
Yeah.
Virginia Beach area.
They said that shit was like extremely organized, extremely clean, like no issues, no fights, no nothing. Everybody was just having a good time. It seemed like
hell
so
yeah.
Many fucking people there. I was like, ah, damn.
Yeah. Pharrell bought out Hove.
Hove and Diddy.
That was lit.
And
that
Snoop.
That was lit. That was, yep, Snoop.
And Missy.
That shit
and
lit.
Fucking, and then the next night, Chris Brown and Trey Songz rock.
Yep. Then they had the, Hove had that B-side shit.
Yeah, Teddy Riley. They brought out Teddy Riley too.
For real?
Yeah.
I didn't see that. I ain't see clips of that.
Yeah. It was a good weekend. Yeah, it was massive one this weekend.
I thought it was dope for the whole shit. Cause first of all, B-Sides Hov is probably better than Hip Hov.
I wish I would know what he did.
Did they, what, like, the songs he did?
Yeah, like all the track listing.
They didn't. But everybody said that shit was dope. Like, you know, I don't know. No, I don't know any people personally that went to that. But like the celebrities and shit, you know, they gonna hype it anyway.
Yeah.
Hov seemed like he did his thing. I thought it was dope that he brought out Nas. You know, he used to have that beef with Nas. Then he brought out Cam. Times. Right. But he brought out Nas and he brought out Cam, which, yeah, and him and Cam just squashed that beef. I mean, this is the first time they've been seen together.
Like, yeah, I guess. But that shit been dead though. Like, them niggas ain't been tripping.
When did it die? Insider. Our whole Insider.
That shit been dead since like fucking, it's like when Jim Jones did that whole balling and all that shit. Like, that shit, that shit been dead, man.
Nah, that was the height of the shit during the balling shit.
Yeah, so after that though, like, so Jim been signed to Roc Nation for like fucking 4 or 5 years.
Yeah, it's been like 3 years. It was like 3 Roc Nation brunches ago, because I keep up with Roc Nation brunch. Because I'm going to the Roc Nation brunch eventually.
That's, I think it was like goals. 4 years, though. Because he done put out 2 albums.
That's cool. That could be right. It could be 4 years. Yeah. I know he went to the Roc Nation brunch recently, and that's when he had signed to Rockefeller. Whichever one with the Roc Nation brunch was inside with two years ago, 3 years ago, whatever. But that was dope. I just thought it was dope that you brought out the niggas that, you know, you used to beef with. And that kind of, to me, that just shows the greatness of Hov, and like he trying to show y'all like this shit. You know what I mean? Like this unity shit and this, you know what I mean? Like, you can have shit happen, but you can always squash that shit if you really want to. You know what I'm saying? You know, I'm Hov Hive anyway. So,
yeah, that shit was dope. I wish I'd have known what songs he did. I know he did Marcy. I know he did. I wonder what the fuck he did. I'm surprised they didn't put that shit on Tidal. I'm surprised for real.
I'm surprised that wasn't on Tidal. Cause that could have been. Yeah, niggas would have been watching.
Yeah, maybe
that
might. I definitely watched that B-side. They might want to like doctor it up or some shit.
Hey, you know, the Hov could be on his Beyonce shit. He trying to sell his shit. You to could. Netflix or some shit.
That'd be smart. They probably got a deal already. I'm pretty sure they got a deal.
Listen, next year I'm trying to be festival shorty. I'm trying to be festival fresh out here, because I'm trying to go to Broccoli next year. I'm trying to go something in the water next year. I'm trying to go to Dreamville next year. And I'm trying to go to Essence next year.
Mm.
No Coachella though. It's mad herpes out there. Yeah, you heard about them 1,000 cases of herpes in Coachella's?
Hey,
Coachella
concert
was pretty quiet this year too. Beyonce kind of killed that shit last year.
That's what I'm saying. Stay with the black people, man.
Beyonce killed Coachella. Like, who gonna follow up Beyonce, man? Like, who gonna follow Beyonce? It was super quiet. All I saw was Diddy's sons out there doing their dance.
Niggas be killing that shit. They same dance they do.
I want that shit to retire. I'm over that fucking dance. They've been doing that dance for 5 fucking years.
That's like, their swag. Let them rock. That shit hard. They killed
fuck
that
shit. Remix that shit. Do some shit. I'm over that shit.
That
I like Diddy Sons though.
That shit was
I'm
fire.
Over that dance though. I'm over that dance though. That shit. Every 5 minutes, shake your shoulders, do your feet. And I'm still okay. So
it was fire.
I still got an unpopular opinion that I do not believe that Justin is Diddy's son.
He looked just like him.
He don't look nothing like him. Christian looked just like Diddy.
His
Them
mom,
other kids
he look like, him,
looked
his
like
mom,
Diddy.
Bro.
He do look like his mom. I don't see no Diddy in that nigga. Like,
I see him.
And what? And his features look like Diddy to you?
Like, he got like that round, like them round cheeks and like chin shit. It's like that part I see it in. He ain't
Diddy
got
kind of like a long face though. Diddy face shaped just like Justin face.
I mean, I don't know.
I don't know.
It.
That's my conspiracy theory. That's why I say my unpopular opinion. He don't give me no Diddy, like. Nothing about him says that. I mean, his characteristics, because I mean, he raised them, and that's allegedly his father. But I was just like, he don't give me no Diddy, bro. Like, no Diddy. But I'm definitely trying to go to a rock of fucking festivals next year. I think that might be on my list next year to hit up these festivals, because the reason I was going to hit something in the water But and a friend of mine planned a trip. They had a beach house and all that out there. I was gonna go, but then I was just like, it's the first year, I'm gonna let them work out the kinks and shit, like, and then I'm gonna go next year. They did have to cancel like the first day though because of the weather or something like that. Something went down. But other than that first day, I think the people got their money back, like, or a portion of their money back or something like that. So that was dope. But that shit seemed like it was super dope. Yeah, it was. And that shit was by the water for real. Did you hear any like incidents happening?
Nah, that's what I said earlier. From what I heard, it was incident free.
That's what's up.
Nobody.
That's what's up. You any festivals on your agenda for this year or next year?
I want to try to do Essence this year, go see my family and shit, like in Louisiana, period. And, but yeah, Essence would be dope.
I want to do Essence. Maybe we can do Essence next year. Pulling live from Essence.
Yeah, it might be dope.
Yeah, but I'm definitely trying. Broccoli and Something in the Water going to have to space it out, like, because they was on the same fucking weekend. Mm-hmm. So it couldn't do that. But Broccoli was at FedEx Field. Usually it's at RFK, so I'm sure it would have been. It was a lot better because, like, last year and the years before when it was at RFK, it was, they said people were sneaking in and shit. You know, RFK, the old Redskins stadium that's actually in D.C.
RFK and Merlin. I didn't know they had one in D.C. I figured it, but every time I had ever passed anything, it was always FedEx Field.
Oh, yeah, that's in Merlin. Mm. RFK is in D.C. It's actually in D.C. So that shit old, too. That's where the DC United was playing. I don't know if they still play there because I don't follow soccer like that.
Mm-hmm.
But that's where the soccer team was playing at.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, I'm definitely trying to hit some festivals next year. I want to say rest in peace to John Singleton.
Absolutely.
Rest in peace, John Singleton, rapper, writer, director. Definitely helped shape Black culture through cinema and all that. Iconic movies. Boys in the Hood, Baby Boy, Poetic Justice, just to name a few. Niggas
shot that. They do Snowfall.
Yep.
Snowfall's fire.
So what's gonna happen with Snowfall?
I don't know, man. I hope he wrote the shit.
You know,
I mean, usually it come out like around toward the end of the summer. Like, so I don't know, man.
Yeah, I do need to catch up on Snowfall. It's been enough seasons for me to actually, I could binge watch that and not feel like it's a lot.
First season is a little slow. Second season is fucking retarded. Like, that shit is
great. Because I only watched like the first maybe two episodes of it, and it kind of fell by the wayside.
That second season is excellent.
Yeah. A few people told me that same thing, for real. Like, the second season is way better than the first season. But I guess you gotta watch the first season to understand the characters and shit in the second season.
It's really good, though. But yeah, rest in peace to the good brother.
Rest in peace. He was only 51 years old, passed away of a stroke, man. It's sad. 51 years old. He looked older than that. I thought he was older than that.
Yeah.
But it's crazy because, like, yo, niggas' hearts is got shit going on. Like, I sent you some shit that, like, Peebo Bryson, Larry King, and Curtis Blow.
Oh, word?
They all in the hospital or about to have, like, a major surgery, like, on their heart and shit.
Damn.
Like, and Curtis Blow, like, that was my dad, nigga. Like, my dad kind of low-key, like, put me on the hip-hop through Curtis Blow.
That's dope.
Because that was, like, his shit, like, that basketball shit. All them old school Curtis Blow songs.
I was watching this nigga that owns Priority Records. Like, he bought it from Eazy-E and shit. Dude named
he Big. Own it now?
Yes. Or no, okay. Excuse me. I don't know. He owns like Bone Thug. His name is Cass, Big Cass. He like a Crip nigga from coincidentally Christian.
That name sounds
he
sound
like a
familiar.
Big light skinned dude. But he was saying how he used to, because he did mass time in jail and shit, but ended up owning Bone and all that other shit. Like, he bought it from Eazy-E or some shit, but he owned Bone, something about with Bone and shit, and Mo Thugs or some shit. But anyway, he was saying, like, I used to sell so much crack to fucking Curtis Blow. He was like, He was like, yo,
crack though.
Yeah, nigga. He was like, that nigga
not
smoked.
Even blow, not even cocaine. That nigga he wanted said it he hard.
Smoke. He was like, that nigga used to smoke $5,000 worth of crack in a fucking weekend. I was like, fuck. What? Yeah.
What?
He was like, he used to serve Magic Johnson and shit, all type of shit. Kelsey Grammer. He was like, yo, he was like, I was 15, like serving blow to Kelsey Grammer shit, and Kelsey Grammer on.
Kelsey Grammer smoked crack.
Nigga, super like. Duper duper.
Nah, that's wild. Yeah, I would definitely put Kelsey Grammer.
Nigga,
as a
Shaq. Cocaine. I mean, not Shaq. Excuse me, Magic Johnson. Like Magic Johnson was getting busy. Like this nigga was in the league
with crack.
Yeah, bro.
Jesus, bro. Crack a different type of shit.
Niggas was getting high, but it was in the beginning. It was when it was first found out. You know what I mean? Like the early
80s. So how do those people smoke crack and not become crackheads?
They got enough money and enough resources, not like to be able to. You know what I mean? Different shit. I don't know.
That's crazy. Crack is crazy. Like
$5,000 worth of crack in the weekend is crazy.
Brian, crack cheap as fuck.
That's mad crack, my nigga.
That's mad crack.
That nigga said that shit. That's what dude said. He was like, $5,000. He was like, yeah, I know. He was like, how the fuck?
You know how many VCRs that is to steal? $5,000 for crack.
Crazy show for fucking Curtis Blow. He going to goddamn pick up that bag and go get some crack. That's crazy.
No, but it's super crazy because, like, I be hearing, like, the stories about, like, you know, majority, like, white guys, white celebrities, especially on rock stars and shit, when they be talking about, like, coke and shit. You know what I mean? Like, how they did so much coke, like, they didn't have no nasal passages and, like, they had to find new ways, like, sticking it up their ass and, like, all any hole in your body, like, they was shoving coke into it. Crack, bro. Ooh, that's a mean joint, man. But yeah, and that could, you know,
could have led to
these heart issues that Curtis Blow had, you know what I'm saying? Like, and strokes and all that shit.
That's
like, that shit crazy. But, you know, rest in peace to John Singleton and prayers up to Peebo Bryson and Larry King and Curtis Blow and all these men, you know, people, period, that, you know, shit. Take care of yourself, man, because it don't matter how much money you have. You can't buy health, that's, you know what I'm saying? Unless you Magic Johnson. But if you ain't Magic Johnson, you can't get healthy off of money. Yeah. Man, but, man, prayers up. Pray for those people, man. Pray for those people. I want to get into Brown and Proud. I want to give a shout out to Kyler Murray.
Yeah.
Kyler Murray became the first person, not black person, but first person, period, to be selected for the first round of the NFL and the MLB draft.
First pick.
My bad. Correct me, because I want to get his brother all the props he deserves. That's an amazing accomplishment.
Absolutely. He should have went with baseball.
Yeah, because it's more money.
You're fucking right. The nigga's getting $500 million for like 7 years and shit. Hell
yeah. Hell yeah.
And it's less stressful on your body and shit. I mean, football is obviously a more exciting sport to probably play, but shit, if you want to damn be an old man, cash and check.
Yeah, it's kind of like, do you want the fame or the fortune? You know what I'm saying?
I mean, you can still be a famous baseball player. You know what I'm saying? Like,
but not like black famous.
Yeah, that's true.
You know what I mean? So that's why I say like the fame or the fortune, like,
I want the fortune and the longevity. Like,
I'm definitely going with fortune.
Niggas be playing for like today, like 38, 39 playing baseball. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, niggas be broken up in football. Yeah, by the nigga, time you they got, fucking 30
you got
for
shit
real.
Shit, to 27, 28, and you got a long career. You know what I'm saying?
And you got CTE.
For sure.
But it was fucked up because your man 45 congratulated that white Trump supporter.
Oh, yeah.
Nick Bosa. And he was the number two pick in the draft and didn't say shit about Kyler Murray. But, I mean, one thing I can say about Trump, he's a consistent asshole.
Oh, yeah. I mean, nothing
he's consistent.
You got to give him a props.
Ain't nothing
that.
Surprising.
Like, you ain't
got to
worry how he coming.
Yeah, you ain't gotta try to worry about or think about or deep dive into how he feel or what he feel. He tell you right there, and he let you know what's up. And hey, it is what it is. But shout out to Kyler and fuck 45 per usual. I want to give another shout out to Nicole Lynn. You heard about Nicole Lynn?
Who was that?
We still in sports. Nicole Lynn is the first black female sports agent to represent a top five draft pick in the NFL. Nicole represents Alabama defensive tackle Quinnen Williams.
Oh, that's
he was
dope.
The third.
That's a nigga that
overall.
Blessed himself on TV.
Yep.
And
yep,
niggas like, yep. Bless me. Thank you.
Hey, that shit was come on, bro. Like, yeah, that nigga. Shit was funny to me because I feel like I done did that before.
Yeah. I ain't never said thank you, but I done blessed myself.
No, I'm gonna tell you what I've done. I've never said bless you to myself, but I've definitely said thank you, and ain't nobody said bless you. I like chew. Thank you. Nobody even give me no blessings.
Motherfucker be like, have a good day or some shit like that doesn't require a thank you, but yeah, thanks. Appreciate it. Or some shit. Not thanks, but
nah,
like,
I know what you're talking about. Like, you talking about when the waitress be like, oh, enjoy your meal. You be like,
you too. Yeah. I'm like, you fucking idiot. You a stupid right. Piece of shit. What the fuck
is I know that guy hit that shit all day.
I be fucking myself up. I'm like, you dumbass. What the fuck?
Or, bro, like when somebody hits you awkward. With the, hey, you know, you be like, you might be like, hey, how you doing? Or something. They be like, hey, I'm good. How you? And then you be like, oh, I'm good. How you?
Yeah, like just
damn,
like,
nigga, just answer
listen,
the question.
The
niggas don't care for real. Motherfuckers just do shit out of habit.
That should be funny as hell. Like, enjoy your food. You too, thanks. Like, bitch, I ain't fucking going nowhere. That's just, I hate this.
Like,
shit.
I don't go to break to motherfucking
like,
5 o'clock. That's funny as
that
shit.
That is funny.
But shout out to Nicole Lynn. Only 5%. Of females,
yeah,
there are only 5% of females that are certified agents in the NFL, and you can only imagine the percentage that are black.
Yeah.
So shout out to her. That's
Uncle Luke wife though. Luke Skywalker the dancer. I mean the dancer, the rapper,
the dancer. Don't do that.
His wife is a she's an agent, or either an agent or a lawyer. But I know she represented this dude named Devontae Freeman. He played for the Falcons. Okay. He used to actually play for Luke in Luke's youth football camp and shit, and ended up being really good, obviously. But yeah, she's like, he's like, she was one of the only ones at that time. So more open the door.
Hey, let's crack that glass ceiling, ladies. Let's get it. Let's get this money, and let's get it. Let's make it happen, man. You ready to get into some lit or shit?
Yeah,
lit or shit. What you sipping on? You already high. You feeling good? What you sipping on?
I got
on?
A little beer in this fucking, what's them cups?
what kind of cup?
The metal cups. You know what I'm talking about? Yetis.
And the little, I thought you were talking about the mule cup.
Oh, nah, that's gay.
What you get? Mules are gay.
You talking
that's
about the little
hell.
Copper shits?
Yeah.
Yeah, nah, that's gay.
They be drinking Moscow mules
that's
out of
for
them.
The ladies.
Class, I got a dark and stormy, and they put it in a mule cup. They was like, "Oh, you drink Moscow mules?" I was like, "Nah, bro."
What is it? Okay, so what's a dark and stormy? What is actually a Moscow mule?
A dark and stormy is like a bourbon ginger beer, and something else. Somebody put me onto it. So like, when I don't get like my usuals, I get one of those. Some Dukes, well, they not Duke students now, but when I was fucking with them, they was PhD students at Duke, and they used to drink them shits all the time, so I get them shits. Yeah. But in a Moscow Mule is a vodka based, right?
Yes, it's Moscow. That's what they drink.
Yeah, that's what they drink there. Let's see. A Moscow Mule is vodka. Oh, it sounds like damn, almost
shit, right?
The same thing. Is vodka? Oh, it's actually the reverse of a dark and stormy. But it sounds like it's vodka, ginger beer, and lime juice.
Oh, word.
Yeah,
it's
like ginger ale, but super fucking strong.
Mm.
A dark and stormy is. Let me get y'all the dark and stormy because
like
I'm drinking shit.
Male stripper coming to the stage.
A dark and stormy is ginger beer, bitters, and dark rum.
Bitters? Actually. What is that?
Bitters are like
shit to make shit bitter. Like a sour.
Yeah,
or some
they
shit
like
that.
These. Yeah, like you. They look like a little berry, like a dehydrated berry looking.
Mm.
See, when I got my bartending license. we wasn't making shit with bitters in it. I probably got the great value bartending license.
Do you gotta renew them shits?
It really just depends on what state you in. Some states don't even require a bartending license.
Oh, okay.
And some do. And some places, they just want you to work your way up the bartender and shit. Like if you work at a chain restaurant or some shit, like they want you to be a server and all that shit.
Right.
That was when I got my bartending license, I was getting a second job. That's when I was still living in North Carolina. I was trying to get like a second job. And then it was like, they wanted you to do all this shit. Look, I'm not a server, bro. Like, that's just not me. Cause I'm not about to be running back and forth to get ketchup and shit.
Yeah,
like,
so,
shout out to the servers though. Cause I know a lot of servers, a lot of waitresses and a lot of bartenders. But shout out to them, but that's just not my cup of tea. You're not about to. And then, you know, it's people always trying to fucking get over on their food and shit.
Me.
You know what I mean? I ain't got time for that's you.
Yeah. Tell you, I'll take some shit back. Nigga, I'll send some food back quick.
But are you trying to get over or your shit?
Nah,
or your food just not right?
I'm just fucking with you. Okay. But I'll send some shit back quick and will not ask for nothing else. I'll get something.
You told me some things about you, got me looking at you out the side.
Oh, yeah, I'm cool.
I ain't gonna put you on blast. I ain't gonna do that. That ain't how I roll. but that shit would have been right in line. I'm like, nigga, don't tell me you do that too, because we gotta evaluate this affiliation.
If it ain't right, I'm like,
no, I refuse to pay for some food that is not up to par.
Right.
Because you want my money, I just want my shit how it's supposed to be.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, for real, for real. And if that shit seems like it's going to be a problem, just give me my money back, because I don't need you spitting in my shit, like, at all. But I'm over here. I'm over here in Bad Boy Diddy Land. So I've been drinking, I tried some Ciroc watermelon this weekend.
Oh, yeah. How was that?
That shit bomb. I mix it with lemonade. Shit great. That's what I'm drinking right now. Ciroc watermelon and lemonade. That might be my drink for the summer if I take some time off the dark. But it's definitely good. I would definitely try it. Diddy, we need a sponsorship. Ooh, speaking of sponsorship, somebody said they might have a sponsorship for us. I need to reach back out to them.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry, making a note.
Yeah, come through.
Reach
come
out
through. If you got
to,
some, hey, if you want to sell some shit, nigga, we got a nice little audience here. So
liquor sponsor.
Yeah.
And it's a liquor distributor.
Oh, yeah. Send bottles, nigga. Send bottles.
Yeah, I was
my
like,
way.
Yeah. We'll do it for some bottles,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Now. Yeah, I mean,
do
like
for the bottles.
Right, exactly. We get it. We gotta work our way up and pay our dues.
Yeah,
we got a good little following, you know what I mean? Like, come on,
nigga, y'all got some cheese out there. We'll do it for some cheese, nigga. Send some cheese. Not like, I mean literally and figuratively. Like we actually have some Kobe or some shit. Like Kobe.
I'll take some motherfucking Gouda or some shit.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Some Sargento.
Sargento,
get the nigga. You know what I'm saying? The niggas like the slices.
All of it.
Sargento cheese fire though. That shit is some good cheese.
Yeah, if you gonna get cheese already sliced, yeah, Sargento.
Sargento doesn't be that hidden.
Sargento, the slice jump, you be getting the like the brick.
Nah,
or
slice.
You get slice. Yeah.
I will though.
Shout out to Sargento. Yeah. It'd be like Sargento and then I'll do craft.
Mm-hmm.
And then like store brand.
Oh, yeah,
like
yeah.
Walmart,
one of them broke
or
weeks.
Publix, or Kroger's. Nah, it ain't even gotta be a broke week. It's whoever got the shit on sale to be completely.
Yeah, sound like a broke week.
Oh well, then I'm always having a broke week.
Yeah.
My week's always.
Nigga, give me all the Sargento. I hit the lot.
No, because Sargento can cost you like $9.
That shit expensive.
Man,
you
shit
fucking around make macaroni and cheese and be like, ah, damn. Like,
yeah, because if I'm gonna pay that much, I just go to the deli.
Because Velveeta
and
like,
get that boar's head or whatever.
That shit is like $9 for the damn little thing, and then you got to get like some Monterey or some fucking not Monterey, what's it, mozzarella, and then some fucking some mochetta, some shit. That shit be high as a motherfucker.
Yeah, listen, for y'all people who always asking for mac and cheeses from people, that shit costs money.
Yeah, that's a fact.
Mac and cheese, it might be the most expensive thing you gonna
that's
eat.
That's a fact.
On Thanksgiving or at a dinner. Like, if you making a big thing of that shit, like, I'm the mac and cheese maker in my family, like, that shit, just for, like, the pan, the big pan of that shit, I ain't even talking about where you gotta make multiple pans of that shit. Just the one pan of that shit gonna cost you at least 50.
Yeah.
And that's cheese. Noodles don't cost shit.
Yeah.
Cheese costs a lot. They're like, oh, can you make two? Can you give me some money, nigga? Because you ain't putting in on this mac and cheese,
nah, you
bro.
Better, like, you better get the small spoon.
Right. And
get that big spoon.
It's constipation nation out here. I be having like six cheeses in my shit. How many cheeses you have in your mac and cheese, bro?
It just depends. Like, if I'm making house shit, probably like usually mozzarella, a little Velveeta for the melting, and then some.
Oh, you use Velveeta?
Yeah. That should be
good. I don't use Velveeta. That seems disgusting.
It doesn't. I use
you
like,
be making that shit on it? We talking about baked mac and cheese. You talking about on the stove?
Yeah.
Huh. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. And then right. I put some block cheese in there. You know what I mean? And then like on the top, I shred it. You know what I mean? Some shredded cheese and shit. And then I just mix that shit all the way up. Fuck it up. My shit be here.
I prefer already shredded. If they got all my shits, like Asiago, all them, if they got that shredded, I do shredded. If I can't find shredded, or it is something like Thanksgiving or Christmas in the whole store out of fucking cheese, then I got to get the blocks so I can shred it.
I like the blocks,
though.
I like the blocks. Like, I cut my shit up in cubes. You know what I mean? Like, I cut it up.
So I be buying cubes. I buy cubes.
Oh, yeah.
I buy the cubes, but I will do blocks. It's just not preferred because I got to sit and do that shit myself. You know what I'm saying? Unless I got like my niece or my sister helping me, like doing them big joints. Like if I'm at my crib or something, I'm making like a small joint. I can do like three cheeses or something. I'm Gucci, like a little pan. But if I'm making like a big pan of that shit, shredding that cheese is crazy. But block of cheese is better. Ask your grandma on them. That is better. But let's toast and let's get capping niggas the fuck up out of here. So I'm interested to see your take on this story regarding Gucci versus the Migos. So in a Flashback Friday post, Gucci posted a picture of him and Migos. And it said, the first day I've met Migos, both through Quavo and Takeoff, both threw away their fake chains they had on because I gave them both two chains off my neck. The same day, Offset called from jail and told me to send racks to his lawyer to get him out. And I did that the same day off our first conversation. No cap. Well, Takeoff wasn't too thrilled about that. And he commented under the picture saying, that's cap, you know that. But I'm so blessed, we gonna leave it at that. Then he said, thank you. In response, Gucci said, boy, it's cap. You ain't forgot. Then he took it even further by posting another picture on Instagram. And it's a picture of him and Quavo. And the caption was, when Guwop called my manager that night. And it changed my life. The truth, big facts, no cap. This is very interesting to me only because we're seeing Gucci change, right? So my question is, whether this story is true or false, is it cool that Gucci put it out there like that?
Nah, that shit lame. What's the point?
Like, Gucci changing.
He's still a retard, though.
Gucci, like, I don't know. Like, it seemed like fat Gucci, belligerent Gucci, lean Gucci. Wasn't this Gucci now that want to be a model?
Gucci be killing me with that underbite. Like, he ain't no cat. He a damn alligator. I'm a fucking swear he got them cash register. Fuck.
He swear.
That shit get on. I hate how he smiles.
Cha-ching mouth. Fucking. And he always smiling.
Because he in like a cash register. Fucking underbite shawty.
I feel like that's lame. I feel like that's lame. The fact that you put this out there like that, like that's lame. Like, even if this was the case, like if you help some niggas out, let them tell that story.
Right.
Let them say, hey, met Gucci. This what happened. He a real nigga. Like, I fuck with him. Like, you know, whatever, whatever. Like, as a nigga who, you know, we are fans of hip hop. You probably like a lot more of the so-called real niggas than I liked. How do you feel about like the impact of social media on the black man?
Oh,
and especially
rap, man.
The real
kill gangster rap for me personally. Like, like niggas be weird, you know what I mean? Like Tip, now Gucci, fucking who else did some weirdo shit? Some other niggas, Jim Jones was all used to be all in his feelings. Cam used to be on his feelings. You know 50. What I'm saying? Who?
50.
But he's just a fucking petty. Social media was actually made for his type of pettiness. You know what I'm saying? Like these other niggas, like prior to that, they had like a mystique about them. You know what I mean? Like that you can kind of just, like I said, last week or week before last, whenever the fuck I was talking about it. But, it's just killed Beanie when Beans was doing his 1-2. You know what I'm saying? Like niggas just be like, I don't know, niggas get lost in the sauce, man. And that shit just kind of ruined, like, niggas. You know what I mean? For me. You know what I mean? So.
Yeah. I think it's interesting because I'm like, were these niggas that we thought were quote unquote real niggas? Were they ever really real niggas? Or has social media changed them to be like these bitch ass niggas?
I think it's changed them, man. Niggas be chasing for fame and likes, man.
Mm.
You know what I mean? Like niggas just still be chasing after certain, like, you know what I mean? Like notoriety, you know what I mean? So yeah. I think like they don't really know how to, like, cause niggas phones in their hand all the time. So some, like, everybody phone be in their hands all the time. So like, it's just like an idle mind and, you know, like a fucking toy for an idle child. Like, you gonna start messing with the shit and then fucking recording yourself. Like, niggas be doing, like, Tyrese and shit. Like, not to say he was a real nigga, but, like, crying in the camera is the weirdest shit in the world to me. Like
facts. I think we talked about this, a bunch of podcasts back. Like, but, yeah.
Like, that is the most, like, woe is me ass nigga I've ever seen in my life. Like, that shit is corny, man. Like, I understand you was beat up about John Singleton. He helped shape and mold your life and significantly, but like to be taking a picture and like with one tear coming out your fucking eye.
Yeah.
Like, if you don't get the fuck out of here, my nigga.
Definitely get the fuck out of here. Like, I've been done with Tyrese.
For sure.
Like, Tyrese, you know how you be so done with a nigga that a nigga can actually do some awesome shit and you wouldn't give a fuck still. Yeah. like, that's how it is. Like, Tyrese, I'm so over Tyrese, bro. Like, I'm so over Tyrese. Like, you're like top 10 lamest niggas in the past 5 years. Like, you lame as fuck, bro. Like, and all you had to do was keep your fucking mouth closed. And then you would have still had these bitches on you thinking that you this and you that right. And whatever. Like, he lame. Like, but the funny thing about it is, like, because everything is so trendy, I feel like even the quote unquote real niggas that's outside of hip hop is following what these hip hop niggas is doing. Like, you see niggas posting retarded shit on social media or listen, mirror selfies. Like, it just be a lot. Niggas be doing a lot. Yeah. Like,
it's no etiquette. Etiquette is just out of here. Like, just certain shit. Like, but it also stands the test of time for the real niggas who do still have social media and still, like, keep their shit, like, on some gangster shit. You know what I mean? Like, they might be in the club bopping, you know what I mean? But they ain't finna be tweeting the fuck out of niggas and at niggas in the comments. That's the wild shit for me. Like, niggas be going crazy in the comments and shit. That shit is weird. Like, I like
and Jeezy, we already talked about niggas being groupies.
Jeezy got a dope Instagram. Fab got a pretty smooth one outside of the weird shit he be wearing sometimes. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just, like, Instagram be for pictures and shit. You know what I'm saying? Or if you do clap back at a nigga, just have it like, I ain't finna be, you know what I mean? Going back and forth. Yeah. It might just be a quick jab, like, you bitch ass nigga. Or, you know what I'm saying? A joke on a nigga like Fab Witty. You know what I'm saying? So back in the Twitter days, he used to joke and shit. You know what I mean? But
Fab did used to like run Twitter for a little
Fab
while.
Was ill on Twitter. Like,
he was ill on Twitter for a while.
Cause he was witty. You know what I'm saying? Twitter's for witty niggas. Like, you can always tell smart and witty motherfuckers, which not saying Tip ain't no witty nigga. He just be chasing. And shit, I just like niggas that like, and women, just people, like, just to have it like a cool Instagram. You know what I mean? You ain't got to be doing all that crazy shit, bro.
Yeah, that's why I don't follow people just because I know them or I like them. Like, if your Instagram is not something I want to look at, then I'm not following you. You know what I mean? Like, I don't follow just because. Like, and motherfuckers who don't even post to be like, why you don't follow me? You don't even post nothing. Why do it matter if I follow you or not?
True.
Or motherfuckers who just take, listen. I feel like I got a PSA for y'all niggas. To y'all motherfuckers who still just posting pictures. And when I say just posting pictures, like, They don't try to get no type of angle. Like, they posting plates and everything is beige. Like, everything you cooked is beige. Like, your picture is not photogenic at all. I ain't even talking about just selfies. I'm talking about blurry ass pictures. Like all types of fucked up pictures. Like, I get it. Like, if you go back 3 years or 4 years or whatever in my Instagram, it might not be the best picture, but it ain't these shits that motherfuckers is still posting. Like, they still posting on a damn flip phone.
Yeah.
Like, like, y'all need to get that shit together, bro. And let me tell y'all another thing. When you go on a trip, or if you having some type of event, Instagram has made it so that you can post up to 10 pictures at one time, right? Pick your best 10 pictures of that shit and one post. Put all them shits in one post. What you not about to do is tie up my fucking timeline with pictures of the event. Like, every fucking picture you take that shit to Facebook.
Yeah.
Unload your whole camera on Facebook. Like, we don't need to see basically the same picture. And it's like, oh, your hand on your hip. Oh, your hand on your side. Now you squatting.
Yeah.
Now you giving the two peace fingers. Another PSA. Grown-ups, we got to let this peace go. We got to let the peace fingers.
So
we
got to
let them shits go. Like, I'm talking about the peace fingers where you doing, like, where you look like a little kid, where you like this. And they like in front of your face and shit.
Oh, yeah, that's what.
Like, that shit is corny. Like, that shit, if you look 12 doing the peace fingers, stop doing that shit.
Unfollow.
I had to tell a friend of ours that. She was like, dang, for real? I was like, yeah, you look 12 in all of your pictures. You do the peace fingers in front of the mouth, in front of the face, in front of the eyes type thing, like peace fingers. Yo, let that shit go. Damn. Instagram is ruining the world.
That's a fact.
Oh, I thought it was pretty dope though that while we on Migos, that Offset reconnected with his pops.
Yeah, that was dope.
After 23 years.
Yeah, that was dope.
That was crazy. Do you have like any friends personally that you know who, like, male friends who don't have no that nah. don't be in that kid's life, like, at all?
Maybe one, but I don't. It's a possible that it's his, so he ain't really pursued it to take no test to find out. But otherwise, nah, all my niggas take care of their kids.
Yeah, that's good. That's good company to keep, man. Like,
I don't know. Shit, I don't be having time because I be with my kids all the time. So.
Right. I just find that crazy. I mean, obviously, look, like, Offset dad probably been through some things, been on drugs and all that type shit, but it's just crazy. It's just crazy to me that you know what I mean? Like, you talked about your own story and shit like that, but I think, like, it's crazy that you know for a fact that you have children out here.
Yeah,
and you ain't even check in. You know what I mean? Like, not, I ain't even talking about no father of the year type shit. I'm just saying, like, damn, like, you can run into your kid on the street and not know it's your kid and shit.
Yep.
Like, that shit is crazy. That shit is crazy. But shout out to all the good dads out there, and, you know, I love that. I love seeing, you know, it's kind of been this thing where it's kind of like, damn, we giving motherfuckers props for doing the basic shit that they supposed to do. But the fact of the matter is, it's a lot of people that's not doing the basic shit. You know what I mean? So that's how that is. But Gucci, this shit Gucci posted, is that litter shit?
I can't fuck with it. Come on, Guap.
Yeah, that shit. It's shit. Like, that's corny to me. Like, Gucci getting cornier. And Keisha Dior, she can't dress to me.
She is.
She be looking a fucking fool. The worst. She be looking a mess.
They be looking,
she
be having a fucking country. Country.
Country.
Yeah, she's the countryest Jamaican girl I've ever seen. She ain't even really cute like that to me either. And she got old ass hands.
I love your random facts about women's bodies that you bring up. Like,
suck.
Her hands, like, when did you see her hands?
When she post,
like,
them.
Oh, so you be looking at hands and feet, this nigga.
I mean, like, I look at all details, like her neck mad old. Like, that's how you tell when a woman old, by her hands or her neck.
Yeah, you can't tell by hands for sure. And necks. I don't really be seeing old necks on black women. Unless they like super old, like for real, like Cicely Tyson old.
Or they get skinny. But white women, they go from fat to skinny. You can tell in their neck.
Oh, true. True. I got a friend that lost a whole bunch of weight.
Me too.
I was like, ooh. You know when you see somebody who lost a whole bunch of weight and they get to a point where you just like, oh shit, you know, you looking good. That's what's up. And then it get to a point where it's like, oh shit, okay, now you look sick. Mm-hmm.
Like, I had to check on my people and shit. But he's straight though. He had some more shit now. Like, it ain't even lap band or gastric. They got some shit they take out your damn gallbladder and shit.
For real?
Yeah.
Some new shit?
Yeah, that shit. Because apparently, like, you know, like your stomach with the gastric and shit, that shit, like, bring the weight back if you don't continue. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
Nine times out of ten, like, people who have gastric aren't the most healthy in terms of, or most active, I should say. So they just fall back into the rut of the normal eating in their stomach. It's a muscle, so it
right.
You know, goes back to normal and shit. So, but apparently with the gallbladder surgery, I guess it has a better keep off the weight result. I don't know what the fuck the technical term that
keep
is.
Keep off the weight result. Yeah. I agree with you. I'm knowing a lot of people, especially.
That was Blue Cross special.
Because it was.
When I worked at Blue Cross, motherfuckers would get that motherfucker like every guy. Like, you see a motherfucker, they be gone for 2 weeks, come back skinny as hell. Like, damn.
Yeah, and then they fucking gastric break because fucking 6 months later, they looking the same.
That shit crazy.
They going back the same. Yeah, that shit crazy because, like you said, it's a muscle. So if you keep stuffing shit in it, it's going to stretch back out. Mm-hmm. But I think it's crazy. With the, I know people who've gotten gastric bypass surgery, but I think it's crazy because it's like for a lot of people, you got to lose weight to even qualify for shit. So if you can lose 20 pounds to qualify for the shit, I feel like
lose another
you should
20.
Be able to lose some more. You know what I mean? But you know, people want, you know, instant gratification.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? But my whole thing about it is losing weight, you got to be able to look good naked. So, if you lose all this weight, but then you look like a whole bag of skin, that defeats the purpose.
You gotta have that.
I'd rather be fat.
For that shit too.
Yeah, you gotta have that. For that shit.
Like, they had to get a tummy tuck and shit like that afterwards.
They gotta get that skin removal surgery. Mm-hmm. And they have to get, like, breast lifts for, like, the I know a dude who had to get, like, I don't think it would be, it might be called a breast lift because it's still called breast for men, but, you know, he was a big dude, so he had like titties. So when he lost all that weight, he had like a bunch of skin like on his chest.
Mm-hmm.
And he had to get like his pecs and shit done, like to reconstruct them shit. Because it was just like a bunch of skin. Like, listen, I'm not talking down on nobody who chooses to get weight loss surgery. It's all good. It's no problem. I know people who have been very successful with it, but for those of y'all who want to get it as a quick fix, it's not going to solve your problems, bro. If you're not about to be healthier and, you know,
shit like a microwave, your food's still going to be cold in the center.
You don't have that hot pocket body where it's still cold.
What the fuck is that? I don't know what the fuck I was talking about.
You high. You high. Yeah. Don't worry about it.
I got mad
about
random thoughts. I'm super high like, right. For some reason.
See, that's why I can't be recording high, bro. Like, I could probably count on two fingers how many times I've been high recording this show. And it ain't been great. Remy Ma. So Remy Ma has been spotted with her ankle bracelet on. After she has been accused of punching her Love and Hip Hop co-star Brittany Taylor in the eye. Brittany posted a video on social media last week, or I think it was last week, and said, Remy, why you do this XYZ? And she definitely had a black eye. According to Brittany, Remy approached her in Irving Plaza in Manhattan last week, and the beef apparently like stems from some comments that Brittany made about Remy's stepdaughter, Dejanay, Papoose's daughter. Brittany claims that she protected Dejanay from some abusive man while they was in Miami. She alleges that fucking Remy said that's not what Deja told her. And then she said Remy got aggressive and punched her in her fucking face. So I don't know if it turned into like to some big altercation, or does Remy punch you in the eye and you be like, oh, all right, cool. Like, he just punched me in my fucking eye. But you know what, the reason this story is crazy to me is because if Remy is charged and convicted with this crime, like, that could be some serious shit for her, because she's still on probation.
Is she on parole or probation?
Whichever one. Which one is it?
She on parole. Well, I don't know. I mean, if it's still the same from when she, her release, she should be on parole. Damn, that's a long ass time. She been on parole for mad long.
It's only been like 3 years.
Has it?
It's only been like 3 years. Maybe four.
Remy been out for a minute, though.
Girl release. Let's see. Well, I know she ain't been making no good fucking music. What I do know is that.
Because All the Way Up came out like 2 years ago, right?
Yeah. Seems like Remy got out of jail on... Yep, she got out in 2014.
Yeah, about five years.
Well, that ankle bracelet is definitely on. What's the difference between parole and probation?
Parole is when you get released from prison.
Okay, and probation is just when you get released from jail.
Not necessarily. That's before you go to jail in most cases.
Probation?
Yeah. Like, if you get arrested and... Well, I mean, if you get arrested and then get out of jail and then you get sentenced, it's usually either, like, you know, like, arrested and just go to the county and then you get out and you go to court and then they put you on probation for X amount of time. Or but usually, I mean, there's some cases where kid, like, you can get, depending on what your sentence is, like my homeboy, he had like 6 months in jail and then he got home and it was like 2 years probation and shit like that. So I mean, it just depends, but more times than not, parole is when you've done an extensive amount of time, like more than a, I guess, a year or so. And then you have certain requirements that you, it's basically probation, but it's just called parole because you were in
prison. It's parole when you've done your time, but you still on like this watch period. Whereas probation is you probably didn't do your full time, but you can go back.
Yeah, if you pretty much. Because like if you, I mean, both of them have suspended sentences. But like probation. More so, I've never been on either one. Now one of them, thankfully, but I know a million motherfuckers who have. But probation is just like, it's, I guess, a lesser charge, if you will. And then you just have to abide by the rules, or you'll go to jail for the suspended sentence that you would have gotten originally.
Got you. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Like I know a lot of motherfuckers who done been to jail, but they ain't my friends, so I don't be sitting around talking about this shit. With them, somebody was telling me, yeah, because you know, like, when you go down, you got to bail somebody out, you got to do X, Y, Z. I'm like, nah, I don't know that. They was like, you ain't never had to bail nobody out. Nope. I don't hang around with people who go to jail. So, I don't know. Like, that's my point in life, not to be in those situations. Yeah. So, no, I don't know. And not that my family and shit, lots of them have been to jail. But I'm not there to bail them out. So, I don't know the procedure. And I prefer to keep it that way, honestly. Do you think Remy's stupid as fuck for possibly fucking up her parole, or do you gotta defend your kids no matter what?
I mean, both of them, but at the same time, you gotta be smart. Like, I ain't about to punch you in your face and risk my freedom, and then I can't take care of my kids. And then I'm trying to take care of my kids, you know what I mean?
Facts. So, I think that's super stupid. Like, you Remy gotta control her anger, you know what I mean? If she did in fact allegedly punch this girl in the eye, somebody punched this girl in the eye, if Remy punched this girl in the eye, I think that that's stupid, only because this not a situation where you needed to defend your daughter, you know what I'm saying? Like, they're around the same age. They can fight it out. You know what I'm saying? It's not like some man went and beat the shit out your daughter and, you know, you wild out and went and tried to kill his ass. You know what I'm saying? This a young girl that's about the same age as your daughter. So, did it really... We don't know the details, but did it really qualify for you going and punching this girl in the face, especially under these types of circumstances. But you know what's crazy is, the thing about it is, I don't really trust no stories that comes out of Mona Scott's camp. All them shits could be planted, could be a loving and loving hip hop storyline. Who knows? Because niggas be selling their soul for these storylines. Because if you don't have nothing to talk about, you don't have no use for them on the show. And I'm not going to lie, I love it that Remy and Papoose have this great relationship and this beautiful baby and, you know, all that shit. But I'm not, watching Remy ain't really doing it, like, from a reality TV standpoint. Like, they really ain't got nothing going on. It don't even necessarily have to be, like, drama. It's always focused on, like, this black love. I get it. Remy makes some music. Like, that's all I want from Remy. I told you, I waited all these years for Remy to get out of fucking prison for her to, the best song was All the Way Up.
Yep.
Yeah, I waited all this time for you and you come out with this. But she did say she ready to make some music. Jay-Z inspired her at the B-Sides concert and now she ready to make some music, but she gonna have to update her style a little bit. B hates Remy.
Yeah, she trash.
B hates Remy. I still got hope for Remy in her rap skills or whatever. But man, Remy risking her parole is litter shit.
Shit.
Two shits. Let me see what we want to talk about. So Chris Rock posted a meme of Whitney Houston, right? And the meme was a pic of Whitney Houston looking a little pissed off and disheveled behind the sunglasses. Y'all done seen this Whitney Houston meme a bunch of times. And the caption on the meme was, me sitting in a meeting that could have been an email, which we all can relate to, right? But Chris Rock took it to another level, and in his personal caption, hurry up, I got crack to smoke.
Like, chill, bro.
Going back to the crack, Bobby Brown wasn't too fond of that shit. And he commented and said, during this time of women empowerment, you choose to use your time to try to humiliate our queen. And then in another post, he followed up, I thought you was a friend of the family. Is this tasteless? Yeah, or just corny, comedy, man.
There's no point. I mean, like, it wasn't, I could see if he was telling a joke and, you know what I mean, but even still, that shit, like, she's dead, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't think you should speak on her in that way. That's just me personally. I ain't fuck with it, you know what I mean? I thought it was, like, pointless and it wasn't even a good joke.
Yeah, that's my thing. Like, if you gonna go out there with your comedy, it gotta land, it gotta be funny, it gotta be some shit where you, I think you talked about this before, but you definitely have to be, in my opinion, to be a good comedian, you have to be smart. You have to be witty. You have to know how to structure shit. Speaking of that Kevin Hart shit was trash.
That shit was horrible.
That shit was trash. I don't even know that we talked. Did we talk about that on this show?
I don't know. That shit was trash.
That shit was trash.
That shit was that incredible. Shit was I ain't even finished. It was so trash.
I want Kevin Hart to just do like his movie thing maybe for a while, get some good material. Y'all hear me say 1,000 times, I used to be a Kevin Hart fan. I'm still a fan of Kevin Hart, the person, the black man getting money, making shit happens. I'm still a fan of that. But the comedy, Poop City.
Yeah,
that shit
good.
Is diarrhea. That shit is trash. Then he went on with this one joke for way too long. I think one of the things about comedy is timing as well. And you got to know when to cut. It was the shit about the gun, about him having guns all over the house and shit.
I didn't even get to that part.
Oh, yeah. That shit was trash. That joke went on for like 10 solid minutes. Mm. And he was doing that thing where comedians be cracking themselves up. But I really think it was like, I don't really think he was cracking himself up.
Nervous energy.
Yeah, like that shit. But going back to Chris Rock and like this comedy, like, it wasn't funny. But another unpopular opinion, I don't think Chris Rock is that funny, period. So This joke definitely wasn't funny. We got on Pusha T about, you know, certain shit that the cover and shit he did with the Whitney shit. You know what I'm saying? And I'm not gonna sit here and act like, oh, Whitney Houston jokes or and things like that are totally off limits. I'm just saying the way that shit is delivered decides if it's tasteless or comedy. And this just landed in the tasteless bucket for me. Like, it was classless and, you know, especially if you was friends with the family.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That's something different. But, yeah, Chris Rock and this whole Whitney Houston shit is litter shit.
Shit.
Dang. Did we get anything that was lit? Nipsey mom went to go see a medium. You hear about that shit?
Yeah, I heard about that.
She went to go talk to a medium and shit. Would you ever talk to a medium?
That's so funny that shit recently just came up. Who the fuck was I talking? Might have been talking to my wife. I don't know. Who the fuck was I talking to that shit? I was talking to somebody about a fucking medium. But, I think it was like a first date or some shit. I don't know what the fuck, but I don't know. That shit would kind of spook me out, man. Like, I don't know. Oh, yeah, yeah. Matter of fact, yeah, I knew. I do remember. It was me and my wife talking about that shit, but. Nah, like, it was like a date or some shit that they met a medium and shit. I'm like, yo, bro, like, you gotta, I'm straight. I don't think so.
Yeah.
I wouldn't go see one. If a motherfucker just start reading me and shit, then, like, we just at a restaurant or some shit, then that's different, but I ain't finna. Which, then that shit even be weird as fuck, too.
I don't really like dealing with stuff on that side.
Yeah.
Like, I just leave shit how it is. You know what I'm saying? Like, shit like that, like, death is like a thing. But also, like, I don't really get involved with shit like psychics and all of that shit either. Cause I think I spoke about this before, but I don't like people planting seeds. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Sure. When they plant seeds, you're going to grow them bitches. You know what I'm saying? And I don't want whatever my future going to be is going to be like, I don't need no sneak peek. And I can carve my destiny. But if you plant this seed, I'm going to go in the direction of what you just put in my head. You know what I'm saying? And yeah, I'll be like, I'm cool. Like, even if somebody came to me like, yo, like, your pops told me to tell you. I'll be like, I'm good. He'll come. Tell him to tell me himself. Like I'm super good. And people mad fraud out here, too. Like, these shows and shit about, like, these mediums and shit. They be like, oh, be healed. You know somebody who name starts with a T.
Mm-hmm. Like, you know what I mean? They're telling me about some shoes. What about the shoes? Right. Nigga, oh, I they're got on shoes today. Shoes.
Right. Did you get some Nikes when you were 10? Yes, I did for Christmas. Yep. That, like, come on, bro. Like, oh, hey, that shit crazy. You see that this, they trying to get this crayon color called Nipsey Blue?
Yeah.
How you feel about that?
No, I'm with it.
Who does blue belong to? Does blue belong to Hov or Nipsey?
Both. I mean, it's all, you know how many different shades of colors there is? Like,
I'm just saying, from a hip hop, in the context of this conversation, who you giving blue to?
I'm giving it fucking Nip and fucking Snoop for being Crips.
Well, that means that means it'll be Crip blue.
And that's cool too.
I don't know. I just thought that shit was funny because somebody was like, we can spend our energy on way better shit than that. Then name it a fucking crayon, fucking Nipsey Blue.
I ain't mad at it.
Yeah, I'm fine with it. I'm fine with it. I just found it funny because Hov used to own blue, before Nipsey. But Nipsey mom going to a medium is litter shit.
That's lit for her, I guess.
Yeah, that's lit for her. I'm cool though. Let's wake your high ass up and go into some Ain't Shit in 2 Cents.
Let's do it.
Ain't Shit in 2 Cents is our listener letter segment where we give advice to listeners who clearly don't care about taking advice from high motherfuckers and people who drink a lot. Today's letter comes from Tyler. I like that name. It's T-Y-L-A.
That's crazy. I work with a girl named Tyler.
Oh, word? Mm. Could be her. It says, Fresh and B, I love your pod. It's in my top two.
It just sounds weird. But, like, you know, not pod because I'm nasty. My mind went to the gutter. Go ahead.
Oh, my God.
I love your pod.
Where did your mind go?
It's so big.
Only you.
So wet.
Only you. Oh. It says it's in my top two. It said, the ancient show in the Reed gives me life. That's where I got my compliment from. Thank you very much, because the Reed is my favorite podcast. It's the only podcast that I make sure I listen to every week, even if it takes me 3 days to listen to that shit nowadays. But that's my favorite podcast, and they successful, and they are goals. So I appreciate you just speaking that, manifesting that we're your faves. I appreciate that. So thank you, Tyler. It said on the previous episode, Fresh said, if you have a vagina, you should never be broke.
Mm.
And I was like, sure, damn, that's so fucking true. That was a low key jewel. I was talking to my best friend about that nugget of knowledge. And we had a debate about using pussy to sustain your lifestyle. Not necessarily selling it, but using it to get the things that you want from these niggas. I want to ask y'all, what is y'all definition? I'm glad you said that, B. She said, I want to know y'all definition of a hoe, a prostitute, and a sexually liberated woman. Read my letter and I'll love y'all forever. Thank you, Tyler.
Goddamn SAT questions. Leave me a breakdown. Give me a fucking introduction in a paragraph.
What's a hoe?
Hoes, prostitute.
What's a hoe?
Prostitute and who else?
And two, and just a sexually liberated woman.
Oh, sexually liberated woman. I think, hoes are.
Let's talk about hoes. What's a hoe?
Hoes.
To you.
Let's just talk about, Carter One
for
all those
hip hop
enthusiasts. Hoes, I think hoes just like, they just freaks. You know what I'm saying? Like, they just fuck for whatever reason. Like, they just want to fuck anything and everything. You know what I mean? Like, they're just like, they just hot in the ass. You know what I mean? Like, a hoe will fuck the whole crew. You know what I mean? Like, she'll fuck friends. She just ain't got no boundaries in terms of, like, she ain't in for the money. She just feel like fucking. But she ain't necessarily fucking, like, just because she's sexually liberated. She just fucking because she just hot in the damn ass and just want to fuck everybody. You know what I mean?
So, does a hoe, is a hoe necessarily a she? Can niggas be hoes?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Okay. Are niggas hoes in general?
Yeah. You're fucking right. Like, yeah. Hell yeah.
Alright, what's your definition of a prostitute?
Prosties? Prosties is a...
Prosties!
They fucking, I mean, for monetary gain. You know what I mean? Like exchange...
So is an escort and a prostitute the same?
Yeah. For sex in exchange
for
money.
If your business is sex.
You said what?
Okay. If your business is
yeah,
sex.
Yeah, like, if you're paid, if, like, you know what I mean? You're a sex worker, hell yeah.
Okay.
And then a sexually liberated woman is just a woman that just likes to have sex. Not necessarily, like, she still has standards and morals, you know what I mean? In terms of, like, she ain't just finna fuck, like, seven niggas and let them nigga run trains on her and shit like that. Or she might, but, like, it's not.
She might. We have listeners who say they like trains.
We do.
But they think they threesome.
Yeah.
They're trains.
Shout out
but
to
we won't
dog.
Go back there. Choo-choo.
Yeah. And she likes good strands of weed. and falls out.
You better be glad B. Hill didn't shout you out, because you know that nigga
will,
notorious.
But, you know, you the dog. You the homie. You be always showing love. But, oh, yeah, shout out to Jessica, too, man. She showed love the other day, last week, for the pod and shit. But,
shout out to Jessica.
But, yeah, what the fuck? I'm high. What were we talking about?
Sexually
liberated, yes. So, yeah, she just might want to fuck, you know what I'm saying? But she ain't, like, she just ain't hot in the ass. You know what I mean? She just, like, she ain't finna wait and bullshit around. She want to fuck a nigga the first night, or she want to fuck a nigga on the seventh date. She can do one or the other. You know what I mean? She just knows who she is in terms of that. So
yeah.
That's how I define those.
A hoe. Let's talk about these hoes. These hoes. I feel like hoes confuse themselves with sexually liberated women, but they fucking for the wrong reasons. Mm. Like, hoes out here fucking because they got deep-seated issues. Like, hoes is either thinking that they gonna fuck a nigga to get love. They think fucking is gonna get them somewhere. or they got like a hole missing in their life and they trying to fulfill it. They got daddy issues. They just giving away pussy to any and everybody.
Yeah, so they give away the pussy and shit, but like sexually liberated women, they just be fucking niggas.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, so, they fucking niggas versus like giving it away. Like, they.
Like, a sexually liberated woman to me. Now, this is not even about body count, because I feel like a sexually liberated woman and a hoe can have the same body count. But the difference to me is your reason why you're doing mm-hmm. it. So a sexually liberated woman could just be like, I see a nigga I like, I'ma fuck him. You know what I mean? It's a nigga that I find attractive. I'm being responsible as far as, you know, protecting myself and shit like that. But I know why I'm doing it. I'm doing it because I like sex. I'm in control of what I do. I'm not looking for no extra. I'm not fucking you because I think fucking you gonna make you like me. I'm not fucking you because my daddy wasn't there. I'm not fucking you to fill some type of void. Right, you gotta have proper pussy management. And I feel like a sexually liberated woman has proper pussy management. Ho is a lifestyle. Ho is something you doing, and everybody know you out here being a hoe. You could be a sexually liberated woman and again have the same body count as a hoe, but you conduct yourself totally fucking different. Like, I would never recommend nobody be a hoe. I would rather you be a prostitute before you be a
That's
hoe.
That's a fact. If you're gonna get something out of the deal, get something out of the deal.
Right.
Instead of your feelings hurt and then, you know what I mean? And fucking all
a prostitute
all
know what this is.
Being in group chats and shit. You know what I mean?
Right. Right. Getting trains ran on you with fucking 5-10 different niggas and fucking everybody in the clique, then wondering why don't nobody want to wife you. You know what I mean?
I've like seen so many.
That's that shit. And, so many. And it is a double standard for
what Jay said, ran up the Tongas, thought them dudes they could trust. I don't know what the fuck they thought. Them niggas fouled just like us.
Exactly.
That's for sure.
Exactly. You know, like, I respect the prostitute. I respect the sex worker, because you know that this is a transaction, and you can be a high end prostitute or a street corner prostitute, but you know, this is a business transaction. You sell pussy for a living. This is just a job. I couldn't be a prostitute, but I respect those who are out here doing it, whether you doing it for drugs or money or whatever your end game is. At least it's a transaction, because sure. hoes out here getting fucked for free.
You can grab you a little burger or something. Nigga, I give you some pussy for a dub. Nigga, gonna give you that dub.
Give me what you got for a poke chop.
Yeah.
Like hoes need therapy. Prostitutes. If you doing
that was actually a dope song. Like, a lot of the shit that he said in that motherfucker was pretty accurate for a hoe.
Right.
You doing hoe activities. Do what you do. Y'all professionals like D-Lay Cool. Pull it on your coattails. We can take a hoe to a hotel. Don't tell everybody, even the mayor. That shit was fire. Shout out to Luda. That was hard.
You finished?
Even the mayor. Look up in the sky. It's a hoe zone there. Come on, player. What's a hoe always? Hoes never close. They open like hallways. That shit was fucking fire. Shit still jamming.
Yeah, I think you got a whole concert. You got something in the water.
I know, right?
A recap for me is a hoe got issues. They trying to fill a void. A prostitute is just a businesswoman. And a sexually liberated woman is in control of herself and her body, and she knows what she wants. And she's not out here with ulterior motives as to why she's out here doing shit. So that's my breakdown, Tyler. What's your one sentence breakdown for each one of these? A hoe is a what?
These hoes. Hoes.
Okay, that's what the hoe is for you.
That's all I got for you.
A prostitute is a what?
Prosties. Getting that chain.
I hope this is helpful. Tyler.
Entrepreneurial spirit. And they pussy. And they vagina.
A entrepreneurial.
Yes.
A pussypreneurial.
Yeah. Pussypreneurial. Pussypreneurial.
Yeah. A pussypreneur.
Yeah, it's weird. It doesn't roll off the tongue well.
And a sexually liberated woman is what?
Gangster.
Is a gangster. Proper pussy management. PPM. Proper pussy management.
What's wild is that's the name of my homeowners association.
It's the PPM. Mm-hmm. You live in a fucking brothel.
I do. Shout out to my place.
Brothel community. But Tyler, hopefully that helped. Our breakdown of it. We'll be interested to know what y'all think. What's the difference between a hoe and a sexually liberated woman and a pussypreneur? But if any of y'all want any more of this A1 advice from Dr.
Bill and the H is silent on you hoes.
And Dr.
you
prosties Fresh.
And you fucking
and you prosties.
I was going to show my be on you prosties. Fuck these hoes. These hoes by their paper.
Hey, exactly. You can get $20 hand job.
Give me $20.
If y'all want to write in us, y'all know what it is. It's the anxious show at gmail.com. And that's the X with the I may, where the I is, and your letter may be read on the show. You ready to get into some free smoke? Free smoke.
Correct. I am.
Let's get into the free smokest of it all. So, free smoke is where we talk about any hot button issue, anything personal, petty, whatever you want to talk about. But today, what I wanted to talk about is there is a thread that's going around or that went around where white people were free to ask questions that they always wanted to know from black people with immunity, right? So I figured, B, we can answer some of these questions for some of these white people.
For the whites. Today. This is cultural and diversity and inclusion class today.
Yes, diversity and inclusion.
This should be $1,200 for your participation. And we'll be taking fees before you exit. Thank you.
All right. So the third says, okay, white people, ask a black person one question you already that you want to know. This is for fun and don't be rude. All right. The first question that I thought was super funny, B, we need to answer for them. Dear black people, why do y'all put sparklers on Hennessy bottles in the club?
That shit is the dumbest fucking thing in the world, Mr. White Man Dan. I'm pretty sure your name is Dan or Todd. Todd, it's a great question. It's the dumbest shit in the world. We are people that haven't had much in life, and we have to make ourselves bigger than life sometimes, even though we don't necessarily have it all. And that sparkler is just for everybody to know that, hey, I got a bottle today, and I may not be able to pay my rent tomorrow, but today, we balling. So, that's what that is. It's just stupid. It's really dumb. I hate it. It ruined the fucking club, in my opinion. That along with fucking tables and fucking the VIP section and shit like that and all that. Ruined it.
Yeah, so to piggyback off of what B. Hill just said, it's exactly that. It's that because of y'all, black people didn't have shit. And so we celebrate everything. We celebrate literally everything. So first of all, what you need to know is that same $35 bottle of Hennessy costs $200 in the club. So if I'm paying $200 for a bottle of Hennessy, I need everybody in the club to see me get this motherfucking bottle of Hennessy. What makes the shit extra funny is when somebody getting like motherfucking some $30 bottle of wine.
Right.
They put sparklers on anything, bro. So that's why, because we ain't never had shit, because y'all keep trying to deprive us of shit. And so we celebrate any moment we possibly can, because that's what black people do.
Yeah.
We make lemonade.
Yeah, man.
We're a professional lemonade maker.
Or Hennessy.
Or Hennessy. Another question that I thought was super funny is, why do y'all run when y'all laugh at somebody?
Because we're animated people, right? That's the reason that you fucking used to fucking have us always dancing and shit, because we just are naturally entertaining, because we're just fucking which is great in that way. So we have to run to like put the additional exclamation points on it and make motherfuckers laugh even more at your silly ass when we make a joke. That's pretty much it.
Hey, that listen, we are a super animated culture. We definitely run. We definitely do extras. We fall out and some shits. Like, first of all, what you need to understand is if niggas run from your joke, play dead on your joke, or start crying on your joke, that shit was fun.
That was fun.
That's a compliment. That's a compliment in the black community. So, Mr. White Man, if you've been around some black people, your black coworkers, or your one black friend, and they ain't never ran from your joke, that shit, you ain't never been funny, bro.
If you've been around several black people and they ran from a joke that just might have happened to come at your expense, it was a really good joke. It was a really, really good joke of motherfuckers. So they roasted your ass or smoked you or goddamn killed you or any other fucking adjective that would describe the level of fucking joke that they just administered on your ass.
Oh,
and I was pretty sure it was the latter of the two. That's why he wanted to know, like, what the fuck happened? Why did everybody run?
Right. Like, why did everybody run? Y'all don't even really be laughing like that at y'all jokes. And y'all be having some crazy jokes. Y'all might just touch a nigga balls or some shit. Like, what the fuck? Y'all idea of funny is putting your balls on a nigga head while he sleep.
Fucking hilarious. I'm sorry. That shit was funny.
Go ahead, pick one.
Your dad's still at the store?
That so is funny. He wanted to know if the dad was still really at the
funny.
Store.
It'll put like the edit. I'm sorry with mad like laughing jokes. That shit was funny.
We got to answer the question. Is your dad still at the store? So the root
nigga,
to
my dad was
the dad's
state,
being at the store. The root to your dad being at the store or being at the military is because y'all separated us from our families.
Oh shit.
Back in the day. What is the theme of this show be here?
Yeah.
All roads lead to slavery.
Project won a project. It was a project.
Exactly. This nigga is quote city when he has a bitch.
Yeah. Nigga, this shit just be. I'm like, dog, this shit is like, you know what I mean? It's like, I'm just in my hip hop. You know what I mean?
Project, because it's a project.
Yeah, nigga. Oh, throw your diamonds in there. B side, nigga. You know what I mean? B, and the B is for B.
Hey, I've been listening to all the hoes for the past week. Like, I just started at the beginning and just whenever I listen to music, I just been putting that shit on.
That's hard.
Because of that shit.
But can't watch
Game of Thrones. So y'all used to separate us from our family, and now men are incarcerated higher than ever. Men are trying to, they're not there with their families. They are indulging in things that get them locked up because of the disparity and the divide in wealth and economics in this country. And that's why our pop's still at the stores. I was blessed enough to grow up with my father, but majority of the people I know did not. And that's crazy.
Mm-hmm.
But
keeping in another one that was funny, why do y'all base everything on horoscope? He stapled his paper. That's some Gemini shit. That's just funny because black people, I don't really know white people to go off zodiac signs and astrology and all that shit. So yeah, I don't know.
Black people
I don't really
definitely
subscribe
go
to that shit. I think if you do some weirdo shit, that's just some weirdo shit. Doesn't necessarily
I
have
definitely
a stigma
subscribe.
Or a fucking horoscope assigned a sign to that shit. But
I definitely subscribe to horoscope. Well, I'm not the type of person like that get horoscope and shit like that, like on a regular basis and shit like that. But there are fucking traits of motherfuckers that are the same, like based on their fucking horoscopes. Like, and if you look at like the people that you've dated and like people that you're super cool with, I bet you will find that it's a couple zodiac signs that they all have in common. Like for me, I know that 9 times out of 10, if I'm vibing with somebody, if I'm attracted to somebody and we kicking it off real good, 9 times out of 10, they probably a Leo, a Libra, or a Sagittarius. All the time. And it just be crazy because I be like, what's your sign? Then they tell me, I was like, God damn, that makes sense. But I try to stay away from all three of them motherfuckers. Capricorns are crazy as a bitch. I'm a Gemini, so people be having mad shit to say about that. I have some Gemini traits for sure.
I think everybody has all those traits, though. Like, that's why I don't really like.
But you don't subscribe, so you don't really pay attention.
I do pay attention, but.
Oh, okay. So tell me about it.
I mean, everybody has the same traits. Like, because people say, like, Gemini's got two sides. Like, they get mad and they're happy or whatever. Like, I'm the same way. Like, I got a quick temper. I'm not a Gemini. You know what I'm saying? Like, but I don't.
No,
hold
I don't think that
long.
Mean quick temper. I don't think that mean quick temper. Like, if I associate a zodiac sign with like a quick temper, Leos definitely have a temper.
Yeah, see, but
like,
I'm an Aries.
Definitely so. Go off.
Like that shit. I mean, I don't know. That shit.
I'm trying to think what I know about Aries. Oh, I know a couple Aries. I know a couple of them motherfuckers. Like y'all, kind of like wishy washy a little bit. Like y'all will be on some shit. And it'd be like the best shit ever or all y'all want to talk about. And then y'all like, nah, I'm cool on that. And you definitely do that. Baby.
Everybody does.
I know
that. A lot of people
areas.
Do that. Like,
but it's dominant traits. So that's what it is. Like it's dominant traits. Like shit that defines you. If somebody said, oh, tell me some shit about this person, 9 times out of 10 is going to be the same shit.
Mm.
I ain't saying it's an exact science. Since I subscribe to the shit, I get with it. I'm with it. I'm with the Gemini shit because I've seen that shit. I've dated other signs and shit like that. But the people that I really be fucking with be those three signs for sure, all day. And I don't really get along with other Geminis like that.
Hmm.
I really don't, and I don't know why. Because I think the Geminis I don't get along with, they ain't like me, but they might say the same shit about me. So I don't really know. I know like as far as that Gemini off on shit, like for me, like I am who I am for what I need when I need to be. Like you see me at work, I'm this person. Outside of work, I'm another person. You gotta, and not saying you're not authentically you. Is that you know what I'm saying, like time and place. Like I know people who be like, damn, like you always smiling, you always having a good time. And I also know people be like, why you on that smile? And I'm just like, I'm not smiling.
I think that's everybody like, though. Like, cause when I be at work, I gotta, you know what I mean? You gotta play a role and there's like a certain, I don't know. That's why I said, I think it's just similarities in people, period. Like, or in differences in people all the way down the line. I don't think it's necessarily when you were born and like what time. Cause I mean, like if I had a crazy ass fucking daddy, and he was born in fucking January, and I got a.
And he a Capricorn, that's why he crazy.
But then I was born in June, Capricorn. And I'm just as crazy as he was. Like, you know what I'm saying? I think it's more hereditary than any fucking thing versus horoscopes and shit, and like what time you were born in the year. But you know, to each his own. Whatever works for you.
The next question is: why do y'all look 20 at 60?
Because it's called melanin.
Facts.
God, that's a facts. Divine order that we have no control over that. We're the original people, which came from Africa. Look it up. The first person that they found on the earth dates back to Africa. And obviously we all know that people that came from Africa are of darker skin and a darker hue, which is melanin. And it protects us from the sun and gives us longevity and a bunch of other shit that's really dope that makes us magic.
Yeah.
And God's people.
Yeah.
Direct descendant from God. So, yeah, you just got away from the sun. And your people don't have that same luxury of having this beautiful melanin. And we, yeah, that's it. That's all I got.
This is fresh and it's payback for slavery. So, y'all were fucking mean to us and it's payback. That's why y'all ate. I don't know if we age slow or y'all just age super fast. I found out the other day that my coworker that I knew for a fact was in her late 40s was younger than me.
Damn.
Like she 33. Bro.
That's crazy.
She told me what year she graduated. I was like, did you go to school right after, did you go to college right after high school? Like, she was like, yeah. I was like, if you don't mind me asking, how old are you? She was like, 33. I'll be 34 this year. I'm like, no fucking way, bro.
Damn.
Like, on God, I thought she was at least 45, 46. At least.
Damn.
At least. That, hey, bro.
Bananas in the sun.
It's that sun. Yeah, we both said at the same time. That sun. That's something. And then, you know, it don't help that they lose their hair quicker. They go bald quicker. No disrespect, B. They lose their hair quicker, so they be like 20, like already with just the side hair and shit. Like that shit be crazy. But that's one of the pros to being black. That melanin, boy, it is great. Why do y'all wear airbrush shirts to funerals?
That's some nigga shit. I don't know. I don't know. That's just stupid. We do a lot of stupid shit. A lot of this shit is stupid. A lot of this shit is God given and ordained.
I don't think it's stupid. I think it's just hood shit. I don't think it's stupid to want to pay homage to somebody.
Yeah,
you know what I mean, that passed away. Whatever. It's just hood
shit. Yeah, that's what it is.
Now I'm not saying I would do that shit. I'm not saying it's a bad thing. I'm just saying I wouldn't be like, yo, let's get airbrush shirts with granny face on it. Like, that's just some hood shit, bro. Somebody said, how come y'all have rhythm and we have to practice?
Because we're the original people.
Back to that, right?
We created everything.
That's it.
We created music. It's God given.
You know, I always wonder about this, like, on a serious fucking note, because black babies can dance. Mm-hmm. They can dance. They know the beat. They know the rhythm. They can dance.
I mean, they were listening to Future the whole fucking pregnancy, so.
They can dance, though. And so, like, when I always try to look at, like, the root of things and the root of people, I always go back to children. You know what I'm saying? Like, because it's just, like, white people can't, like, do y'all hear it different?
Yeah.
Like, are y'all on the one and the, like, it's the one and the three, and then it's, like, the two and four? Like, what beat are y'all on? Like, is the music hitting y'all ear different so that y'all bodies is not catching up?
Gotta be.
Or your body and your brain is just not on the same page? Because dancing is not something you have to think about. Rhythm just comes. You just innate. Move. The beat come on. Yes. Yes, it's innate. You just move. So that's the question I have for white people. Like, how do y'all hear the music? So when you do see, like, a white person, especially, like, now, I feel like one of my favorite little guys on Instagram is Seth. He be dancing like shit, and he look like a certified public accountant. But he be dancing like shit, and he probably, like, 10 or some shit. He be doing all the fucking dances and shit. But, like, these newer kids, they learning how to dance and shit. So is it just that y'all got to, like, really study at it for the most part? Or your feet is doing a whole different thing? Or you just hear the song different? That's why I feel like heavy metal was invented. Because heavy metal don't have no fucking beat to it. It's just a bunch of noise.
It be doing, not like, nah, it still be having a beat, though. It be like, dun, 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 dun,
not rock and roll.
Dun, 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 dun. It's just like, it's,
it'd be like, yeah,
it's a different,
like,
type of beat. Da, 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 it's not, da, da, da.
And then it'd be like, it ain't something where you could catch a beat to that shit. How do you dance? You just wave. You just move your body. You just thrash yourself around. Yeah. Like, it's no, like, a dance that goes with heavy metal.
Some of that shit be soulful, though. Like, Teen Spirit is fucking, that shit got a mean beat.
That's not heavy metal. That's rock.
That shit was hard.
That's not, you talking about that grunge rock shit. I'm talking about heavy metal.
Nigga, that shit was they fucking heavy metal.
Teen Spirit was not fucking heavy metal. That was grunge.
Yeah, but it's still rock and roll. I mean, it's still loud.
Rock and roll and heavy metal. Yeah. Rock and roll had their rhythm.
Yeah, yeah. That nigga yelling like shit, that's fucking heavy metal.
You think about rock and roll. Rock and roll and heavy metal is two separate genres of music.
It ain't far off, though.
I mean, it's both white. That's the thing they have in common.
Mad guitars and shit.
Yeah, yeah, they do have guitars, but
Teen Spirit,
rock
shit,
and roll though. Has a rhythm. Rock and roll has a flow to it. Like, you can still catch a beat from it. Like, you can still catch something. Heavy metal is just that, heavy metal. But fucking
shit,
noise,
like
clanking,
Metallica
and shit.
Metallica had some bops.
Like,
I don't know, but I know.
See, that's that shit we do. We always will make a blanket statement
shit,
and then,
like,
have shit.
I'm not, like,
because you don't know.
I'm not the white
correspondent. If it's a bad bop, for some of you to put that title on it, you should at least know exactly.
Just chill, I got you.
You always do that shit, bro.
Relax, I got you.
You always do that shit. Go ahead, look it up. So you can say what bops it was.
Top songs.
Nigga saying bops is funny to me too.
I don't know. Nothing Else Matters was hard.
I don't even know.
Yeah, that. So it's like if I told you, like, oh, okay, yeah. So what's the point?
Go. I mean, if it's a bop, that means it was a hit. Like, most people should know that shit.
Here Comes Revenge, all type of shit. They got mad shit.
Sing that shit. Sing Here Comes Revenge.
I don't know. I ain't gonna sing it.
That nigga lying. Don't listen to shit B. Hill saying right now. That nigga just saying shit because he don't know none of these fucking
Fuel.
Songs he
oh,
talking
Fuel
about.
Fuel was hard, man. Hold on.
Sing it. Don't mention another song unless you about to
Fuel,
sing it.
I don't know how it go.
All right, next question. Why can't y'all swim?
I don't know. I can swim. I don't know what these other niggas doing.
All right, I'll tell you why we can't swim. Again, it goes back to segregation. There weren't pools. We didn't have pools. We didn't have pools and shit in our communities and shit like that. So we never really learned how to swim. Like, a lot of us can't swim. I can't swim. I'm definitely a nigga that can't swim.
That's crazy. You should get those, go take some swimming lessons, bro.
Thank you. I appreciate you giving me that life lesson. Like,
you should.
That was it. That was great.
I mean, you should though.
But yeah, that's why we can't swim. You know what I mean? Like, that's what it is. We didn't have pools. We didn't have community centers, and then they fucking segregated the pools and shit. Like, so if your parents can't swim, your parents' can't swim, your ass can't swim. I'm glad that, you know, these days, especially newer parents and shit like that, they giving their kids like swim lessons and kids learning how to swim and shit like super
early. My kids swim.
Like,
all three of my kids swim.
That's dope. I think that's dope. I think that, you know, we should teach our children and shit to swim just so for safety reasons. Not necessarily you want to go out here and be damn, I was about to say fucking Michael Strahan. Hey, what's the nigga name? What's the swimming nigga
Michael
name? The
Phelps.
Michael nigga. Phelps. Why the fuck? Michael Strahan swimming with that gap in his mouth is funny to me. Oh, pick one last one and we gonna wrap it up.
Let's see what we got here. Coming. Close out of it. Let's see what else we got. Oh, why do you think we don't use washcloths? Because y'all don't.
Oh, I was going to pick that one too. That's a good one to end
on.
Yeah,
because y'all don't. I've seen it. I had a lot of white friends coming up in the world, and they didn't. They just used body wash, and that was with their hand. Maybe a loofah
with their hands.
On a, if they're getting freaky. But, yeah, nah. Them niggas.
Yeah.
I had sex with
no,
white
I'm
girls
with
and
you
they
on
didn't
that.
Fucking use the rag. They use the soap. Had to throw the fucking soap away. Bitch, you just don't put
that sounds racist as fuck.
It's true.
Oh my gosh. Oh man. Shout out to Mike. I'm white.
Yeah, Mike, my man. I love white people. Don't get it fucked up.
Nah, I know. I was just like, I know he be listening to this shit cringing sometimes, but Mike, we ain't talking about
nah,
you.
Nah, we talking about
if this shit don't
you,
apply.
But Mike,
if it do apply, we talking to you. And Mike from Cali.
Oh, yeah,
so,
Mike.
You know
Mike,
what I mean?
He,
you know, they real wild out
yeah,
in Cali.
Yeah, he shower outside. He got an outside shower. He shower at the beach.
Listen, I've had at the beach and shit. Listen, I've had wild conversations with white people. Like I said, I've grown up where I've been especially when I lived in Wisconsin, being the only black kid in my class or being the only black kid in my grade. And I had white friends and I would spend the night over their house and shit. And, you know what I mean? Like, it's just different. Like, it's different.
It's fun though.
I've literally heard a white person say, why wash your feet if your feet is in the water in the shower? And so we already know, like, a lot of white people don't believe in germs.
True.
Like, they go in the break room food and touch it and double dip and all that shit. We believe in germs, my nigga. Like, we believe in germs. You go in there,
boss, she just texted me. We got, like, some lawyers coming into town to give some trainers tomorrow. And she's actually white, but she's funny because one of the lawyers was, like, he wild as hell. So he always, like, doing some, like, crossing the boundaries type shit. And he was like, yeah. She was like, he just tried to offer me his fucking food out his like off his fork. He was like, no, the fuck, I don't want that shit. And like, bro, when I was in his house in Vegas and shit, like, he was like, he had mad little airplane bottles and he would like drink half the shot. He was like, share a shot. And I'm like, nigga, I'm not sharing your shot. What the fuck?
No, they definitely be trying to
share
bro.
A shot. Share like a shot, man. Nah. It's an airplane bottle
with,
for one. So no.
Right, exactly. Personal. Thank you for being nice. No, you can just pass me
one, the other one that's in your hand that hasn't been open. The fuck?
Nah, they do get wild. It's this chick at my job, and she always trying to offer me some food. But one, I've seen your car. Two, I know you have 20 pets, and I'm not trying to damn fucking get a half of your sandwich and get pink eye. Like, I'm not.
That's crazy.
Like, shit be Justin, crazy.
You,
like,
you eat some pink eye. That shit coming from the backside.
Yeah.
get pink eye from the backside. Like, what the fuck? Yeah, damn. What the fuck?
I had baboon butt. What
the fuck? Like, damn. What the hell? Like, my throat got pink eye. Some bullshit. Fuck.
Listen, y'all got to start using washcloths.
That's
man.
A fact.
Like,
so what do you do when you go when you go buy towels? Like, just get mad towels and not washcloths? Like, what do you think they have the washcloths there for? Like, why do you think they sell them? They want you to buy them.
For black people?
To use them.
They want them the blacks only towels. The washcloths is for the blacks.
Nigga towels.
These nigga towels.
Pass me some of them nigga towels, would you?
Man, the big towels is the white.
These the coon towels. The fuck?
Listen, in most black homes, even if you don't have a big draw off towel, you got the washcloth.
Yeah, nigga, you ain't really
like you
got
your hood cousins.
Cloth.
You got washcloth. Yeah.
Shit got funky. Y'all niggas ain't real. I didn't have to draw off with a goddamn washcloth. Well, you be very strategic in the areas that you draw. Because sooner or later, that towel's going to be kind of wet.
Strategic.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, yeah, y'all gotta use washcloth, man. Y'all got, and I use two washcloths.
Nigga, I ain't had no washcloths. I remember I had to cut a big towel in force.
But you did it though, bro.
Oh, yeah,
like
for sure.
You did. You got to do
hell
it.
Yeah.
Hey,
nigga, I cut it in.
Oh,
no,
that's
it
that
in
nigga
fours.
Ingenuity.
I cut it
man.
In halves, like so. I cut it in half, and then I cut one like to make two washcloths, and goddamn, I was drying off with like a hand towel and shit. You know what I'm saying? I'm fucked up.
Nigga, you cut that shit in a slant like a sandwich.
Yeah, nigga.
You cut the crust off the towel and shit.
I still got that goddamn towel. One of them towels. That'd be fucking... It remind me
Wait,
of the struggle.
Is it so
me?
You never forget where you came from? So you won't forget
grounded,
where you came from?
You know what I mean? I wash the bathtub with that shit now, though. You know what I mean? It's my cleanup towel.
Is that the towel? That's the towel to keep you humble.
Yes. You know what I mean? It's for grounding.
Hey, y'all gotta start using towels though, and stop just putting the soap on your body and like getting out. The only thing I feel like a lot of white people do diligently is wash their hair.
They got to.
Yeah, yeah, you have to. But white people, that was your pass to ask us questions. Don't forget, don't touch our hair. We don't like that. And I want to thank y'all for listening. Make sure you subscribe to the show. Follow us at the Ain't Shit Show or at. Damn. Now, how my liquor gonna kick in at the very end? Follow us at the Ain't Shit Show. That's the X where the I will be on social media, on Twitter, IG, Facebook, YouTube. We also on Spotify, iHeartRadio, Google Play, and Apple Podcasts. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Thanks for everybody who always shouting us out.
That's a fact.
Thanks for all the love. Thanks for our listenership. We really,
Real
really, really appreciate y'all. Shout out to the new listeners. Shout out to the individuals I met last week at that podcasters meetup. That was pretty dope. Learned some things. Got to promote the show. So if you listening, shout out to y'all. And y'all know that we like to end the show on a quote, but I'm actually going to use this quote section to recite a lyric from Hov's freestyle for Nipsey. All right. So I'm going to say it. I'm not going to rap it. It says, so now we fighting over scraps, crabs in a barrel, but crabs don't belong in a barrel. They ain't never tell us that. So in the barrel, we going to act how we going to act. We can easily get out the barrel if we just stand on each other's back.
I'm
that's where he's so
damn,
dope.
That's fire.
He's so
bitch
dope.
Ain't right. None
he's,
of that
he's
shit.
He's so
man.
Dope.
Nigga sharp,
bro. Nah, smartest guy. I love Ho. But until next week, I want y'all to be great and the marathon continues.
TMC.
We out.